Hello, party people, and welcome to this final home game of the year for the Loras College Dewhawks. It's a beautiful day for football, a little chilly, but we don't mind that at all, do we, EJ?
No, not at all. Great day. We got senior day here. I'm really excited for this game, Hugh.
Yeah, we both know that there's a lot of talent out here in the Rock Bowl today, but there are always some players that seem to stand out just a little bit more than the others. Who are you going to have your eyes on today, EJ?
Well, today, leading the Dewhawk offense, once again, we got Siggy. Last time against this Luther Norse team, he had 177 rushing yards and 3 rushing touchdowns. Look for the ground attack. And then for the Norse on defense, they have Sam Bundy has 62 tackles so far, so that's very impressive. And then on the Norse offense, their leading receiver is Andre Atkins, who's 807 yards and 5 touchdowns, so just under 90 yards per game for Andre Atkins. So the two lone bright spots, I would say, for this Norse team, who's kind of struggled so far going into the year, 0-9.
And then now we're going to toss it down to our sideline man, Cade Messer. Cade, what do you got for us today?
Thanks, guys. Just moments ago, the Dewhawks honored 29 seniors who will be playing their final game here today at the Rock Bowl. And boy, could you not ask for a better day for some football. Field temperature right now is 57 degrees with a slight breeze out of the west, 5 to 10 miles an hour. Back to you guys.
Awesome, Cade. Thank you. I mean, he's looking pretty sharp today, too.
Very spiffy. But, Cade, I mean, it's senior day. I mean, you got to come looking right, you know?
Great intake to him. By him with the weather, too. Yeah. I mean, come on now.
He's on top of it.
Making a strong case on his first day on camera.
So, Loras gets the ball. Let's go. Set the tone.
So, EJ, looking at the Luther defense, since they'll be out there first, who do you got starting for the Luther defense?
All right, starting on the D-line, excuse me, we got Ian Clear, Josh Maintenich, Levi Walter, Jeremy Whalen at linebacker, Zach Olson at linebacker, Bryce Noose at linebacker, and Matt Kanda at linebacker. Then in the secondary, we got Xavier Andrade, Brandon Deese, Mike Nunez, Sam Bundy, and doing the punting, Stane Larson, and punt return is Sam Zegler Evans.
Who do you got now for the Dewhawk defense? I mean, Dewhawk offense.
Dewhawk offense, as always, we got good old number 6, Noah Sigworth, catching the snaps at QB. We got running backs Ty Bosch and Eli Thomas, tight ends Mike McDevitt and Hunter Machi, wide receivers Dwayne Emulis, Cabron Cook, Marty McGovern and Michael Crawford, and in the slot we got Javon Williams and Harrison Willis. At left tackle we got Sean Corgeglass, left guard Mitchell Husengay, good to see him back. Mm-hmm. At center we got Ben Boffman, at right guard we got Derek Olcott, and at right tackle we have Drake Sorensen.
I mean, looking like it's going to be a great day for football.
Yeah.
Hopefully this Dewhawk offense can strike fast and early on this opening drive.
Yeah, this Norse defense has not put up much of a fight so far this year, averaging 47 points given up to only 12 the Norse are scoring. They've allowed 45 trips into the red zone, and teams have scored 40 of those 45 times.
Almost sounds like a little bit like that Packer defense, allowed 15 straight scores in the red zone, and the first kick is a little scooch kick and is recovered there by the Dewhawks.
Mike McDevitt just fell on it right there. Kicking it to the senior.
Great way to start it, giving it to the senior.
Yeah. It would have been sick if he had a house call.
Oh, that would have got the day going early for the Dewhawks. Crowd isn't quite into it yet, but I'm sure that'll change with time.
Oh, yeah. Once Siggy busts a
big one.
Yard run.
Oh, a little trickery. Eli in the open. Eli, he's got one man to beat. Eli's going to take it all the way to the house maybe on this first play. Eli to the crib for 6.
Let's go.
He walked with the touchdown to start it early.
The trick play. Looked like he might have gotten caught in between the tackles right there, but once he got the edge, nobody's catching Eli.
That was a great way to start it for the Dewhawks, and we almost kind of called that a little
bit. Yeah, wow.
I did not expect that to happen.
The fans are
faked the handed off to Ty, and Ty just gave it right to Eli, and Eli just broke that one to the house using that getaway speed.
Well, at least they didn't allow a score in the red zone this time, I guess.
I really got the blood pumping first play of the game.
Good to see that.
Farfan's kick is blocked. And the refs blow this one dead.
That's been a one of the struggling points for this Loras team is extra points and punts.
As the replays here, and as you can see, Eli just using that getaway speed. Almost got brought down, but powered through that one and took that one into the end zone. Ooh, getting that little dance too. Okay.
Yeah. All right.
Now, who are we looking at here for the Luther offense, EJ?
Andre Atkins is their whole vocal point. He's averaging just under 90 yards a game. That's really the brightest spot for this Luther our offense, put it in a nice way. They've had some quarterback changes recently. They got a sophomore starting now.
Alex Griffith, I believe.
I think we said it's their third different quarterback this year.
Yeah. They've battled a lot of injuries so far in this year. As I believe Zach Talbot is back after his injury. Good to see him back out there. Zach's kick is up, and it's a good one. Luther returning this one. Brought down around the 29-yard line. This Duhok defense coming out here now, and they've been pretty consistent all year round, I'd say.
Yeah, pretty solid defense so far this year, averaging just a little over 200 yards a game given up. Nothing too bad.
And they have 23 sacks on the year as
well. Yeah, 23 sacks. Averaging, I think they're giving up 33 points a game this year.
And they do spend quite a few minutes on the field during the game, too.
Oh, yeah, they definitely spend the majority of the time between the offense, because when the offense is going, it's a fast-paced offense anyway, so they're not moving.
As they fake the pass, hand off to the running back, who loses yards on the play.
Great play right there by Josh Jones, I believe. 29 for Sean
Brooks on the carry. Looks like it was a gain of nothing there. No gain on the play. Brings up second down. Now, on this Duhok defense, are you going to be looking more up front or on the secondary for today's game?
They're going to try to sling it to their guys, so I think they're going to try to test the Foleys and our safeties and coverage a lot, so we might have to focus on secondary this game, but the defensive line is going to do their thing as always, and the linebackers.
And those Foley bros are going to do their thing as well. As they hand it off again, this time he goes nowhere once again. This Duhok defensive line has come to play so far.
Yeah. Great contain right there in that play.
You were pretty good at keeping contain when you were on that D-line, weren't you, EJ?
Yeah, totally, yeah.
What were you, more of a pass rusher?
Yeah, definitely.
Not a fan of the run?
I could get my nose dirty sometimes, but...
When you wanted to.
Nah, I was never... always been a little underweight for D-line, so definitely speed rush is my move.
Luther sending a man in motion. Quarterback, three-step drop, gets out of his hands quickly and throws it to his man, who is brought down by a Foley brother, and then there's a flag on the play.
Have to imagine it's either holding or roughing the passer. It was pretty late, though. So
Joey Foley with the tackle there for the Duhawks. So we wait to get the call from the ref.
Yep. Defense number 98. And Sam Jones. Had his hand to the run. Automatic
first down. That hurts the Duhawks right off the bat. They've struggled with the penalties this year. They've really hurt themselves with that. And, I mean, once again, we're seeing it. It's almost been like a reoccurring theme so far.
Yeah, penalties have killed the Duhawks this year. And that's one thing I will say about Luther is they have very few penalties this year. I believe they only had 15.
So a lot better than us Duhawks we got here.
Oh, see a shift here.
Ooh, Luther getting a little trickery out here. Griffith fakes a handoff to his running back, who gets a little bit of daylight and gets a gain around 2 yards there.
Still nothing cooking on the run game for the North.
Rashawn Brooks, the running back on the play, and there's a Duhawk down on the field. I can't see who it is quite yet.
I believe that might be Sam Jones.
Sam Jones, a senior. He's been a key part of this Duhawk defense all year round and then last season as well.
Yeah, he leads the Duhawk defense with 8.5 sacks this year. never good to see.
Mm-mm. Glad to see he's able to get up and walk off on his own power, though.
Hopefully just a cramp or a stinger or something.
Hopefully he's able to get back in this, especially on senior day.
Yeah. Oh, he's a tough guy. He's going back in. There's no way he's going to leave first quarter unless it's something super serious. Mm-hmm.
As this Luther offense comes back out here, Alex Griffith under center. Well, not under center, in shotgun. And it looks like he's got Rashawn Brooks right next to him in the shotgun formation. Griffith stepping back. He's pressured. A screen pass, and there's nobody there. Going for his running back. And just couldn't get anything out of it.
Very dangerous throw right there. Mm-hmm. Two Duhawks right around the ball. Two guys coming right at you. Lucky it could have been a lot worse for the Norse right there.
The Duhawks sniffed that one out, and they guarded the running back there, too. Could have been an interception, like you said. Could have been a lot worse.
Yeah, it's always on the D-line to recognize its screen because, you know, the offensive line will usually block you for half a second, and then they'll let you go. And you just got to be able to feel that they're going to let you go and turn around and find the running back.
Mm-hmm. Griffith and Brooks in the backfield once again. Griffith, three-step drop back. Gets out of his hands quick and overthrows his man. Number 44 for the Duhawks. Josh Jones on the coverage there making that stop.
Mason Morris came in like a heat-seeking missile that play and absolutely lit up Griffith in the pocket right there.
Luther bringing out the punt team, it looks like. And their punter is Thane Larson, a sophomore, 6'1", 175.
I don't know if you saw last week, but BV upset Warper.
I did see that. That's kind of crazy.
I believe it was a last-second touchdown, too.
Oh, those were always nice. The Duhawks get in there. The punt is up and away, and Ty's going to let this one bounce, and it takes Norse bounce.
Ah.
Oh, the Duhawks stopped on, looks like, the one-yard line.
That punt took some Norse bounce for sure.
It did. Duhawks coming back out here after their one-play drive touchdown and pinned back and on their one-yard line. I'm going to assume they're just going to hand this one off to Ty here.
Yeah. Or maybe try to get Siggy moving in the pocket, just give him the option to run or dump it off somewhere.
Sigworth and Ty in the pistol formation. Sigworth gets the snap, hands off to Ty. Ty bouncing it outside. Ty's got a hole.
Go.
Ty is going to everybody beat. Ty, he's going to get caught, though.
Oh.
Maybe.
Keep going.
Ty, and he's brought down by a touchdown-saving tackle by the Norse. Ty, flipping field position there for the Duhawks.
Yeah, this Norse defense it's not looked like they're come to play so far.
It does not, no.
Two plays, two 50-plus yard runs so far. Wow, and I was about to say, what if we bust another like 99-yard run right here?
He almost did it, too.
Yeah.
Slowed down a little bit at the end. That's what got him caught. And he looks like he's come out of the game now, and Eli's checked in for him.
He needs to catch his breath.
Sigworth keeps it on the read option. Makes a move. Brought down after this pretty solid game, around 6 yards there for the Duhawks.
Yeah, great move right there. It looked like there's nothing going. He didn't have the edge, but cuts it right back up.
Duhawks bringing in, I believe that's senior running back, number 32, Eric Roddick.
Duhawks looking fresh coming off their bye.
That's what those byes are needed for.
Yep.
Rest up, heal up from injuries, all that good stuff. Sigworth and Roddick in the backfield. Sigworth, three-step drop. Gets it off to, I believe that is Marty McGovern.
Yep.
And looks like the rest are going to give him the first down with the forward progress.
Great pitch and catch right there by the Duhawks.
Duhawks, this is the best we've seen their offense look all year round.
Yeah, they came out like shy of a cannon.
Yeah.
Right now. Their intensity is high spirit, you know.
I mean, senior day, why not come out with
exactly.
that?
Exactly. Your last game in the Rock Bowl, leave it all on the field.
Think they're going to give it to the senior running back, Roddick, here for a touchdown maybe?
Yeah, I would not be surprised if they have two tight ends on the field, too.
Duhawks send a man in motion. Sigworth roaming out of the pocket, and his pass is batted down by Luther Norris. Had a big defensive lineman there in Sigworth's face, giving that pressure.
Yeah, it was Matt Canada right there, knocking it down. Both these teams' last game was against the Central Dutch. Both not too close of a game.
No.
Central is
Central's
an amazing
a very
team.
Good team.
They have the D3 Heisman, who when they played Loras, he had not thrown a pick. I don't know if that's changed since.
I mean, it was a tough game for the Duhawks as they hand off to the senior running back, who is brought down immediately with no gain. Bringing up a 3rd and 10 here for the Duhawks on their own 11-yard line. Scratch that 13-yard line.
To get a decent gain here, I have to imagine they'd go for it, too.
Mm-hmm. Sigworth in the pistol formation. McGovern motions over. Sigworth dropping back. Gets off to Dwayne. Dwayne scores it for the touchdown. Duhawks for 6. Put it on the board.
Yeah, and the outside linebacker right there had an option to stay in the middle of the field or go in the flat and take Ty. And as Siggy usually likes to dump it down to Ty, so he started going away from Dwayne in the middle of the field and left a wide open hole.
Looks like the Duhawks are faking like they're going to go for 2. We really knew they were going to kick
that
one.
Yeah, they got to hand one off to Farfan once, so it's senior day. Come on.
Why not give them something?
Now's the time.
Farfan's previous extra point attempt was blocked. This one is up, and looks like it is good. Yep. Giving the Duhawks a 13-0 lead here. As we see the replay coming in now. Sigurd just made the good read to Dwayne, and Dwayne just took it in. That's senior-to-senior connection.
Doesn't get easier than that.
No. It's a good read by Sigworth, too.
Yeah.
You know, I feel like Sigworth usually likes to scramble in the pocket, but for the most part today, the little bit we've seen him pass it, he's really been a pocket passer.
Yeah, he hasn't really needed much time. People have been open, and his all offensive line has been giving them time. Favorite song, Hugh?
It's a very good song, EJ. Can't fault me for it, man. Who doesn't love a little Ozzy?
Very true.
Ah, they cut it short.
Probably Bats. I don't think Bats are fans of Ozzy Osbourne since he ripped one's head off at a concert.
Yeah, probably. Look at you bringing in all these facts.
Yeah,
such a good color guy. You know everything.
Thank you.
Talbot's kick is up, and it is away. It's a short little one, and I believe Luther Fair caught that one as the ref was motioning for the clock to start.
You should tell my girlfriend that line that I know everything. I think she would disagree with that.
Oh, come on now. You got to give yourself more faith in that. I'll hype you up.
All right, thank you, Hugh. I appreciate it.
Yeah, I got you. As the Luther offense trots back onto the field, and I'm going to be honest, they didn't look overly good that first drive.
No.
I mean, they got a first down due to roughing the passer, but other than that.
I think they should start running some play action or start passing the ball on first and second down instead of running it every time. It has not worked so far as they run
As they run it right here on a little jet sweep touch pass, and I believe, was that Brett Bauer making that play there?
Jace Gwynn.
No, Jace Gwynn.
Who says corners can't tackle, right?
Yeah. And that's actually one of the strong suits I feel like this Duhawk cornerbacks have.
Yeah, they tackle.
Yeah.
They tackle.
The Foley brothers really like to hit.
Yeah, Jack Foley with all those tackles for a loss.
And a lot of time you'll see Jack come in on a blitz, and he'll just come in on touch, too, because they just don't expect it. Griffith in the backfield, drops back, overthrows his man by a good margin. Jack Foley on the coverage there.
Yeah.
Intended receiver there was Andre Atkins, the junior.
Yeah, that was well overthrown right there. Never had a chance. pretty decent coverage there by Jack Foley, too.
Yeah.
See Sam Jones back on the field. It's good to see.
Like you said, he's a tough guy.
Yeah. I mean, senior day, I knew there's no way he wasn't going to go back in unless the trainer literally told him.
Told him he couldn't.
Yeah.
And then he might even put up a fight.
Yeah.
The Norse. Drop back. Looks like a screen pass. Lobbing it up.
Oh!
Almost intercepted there by the Dewhawks. Josh Jones the one making a play there.
Wow, we are sniffing out these screens today. You could hear them yelling from all the way up here, screen.
Mm-hmm. And just like that, Luther's going to bring out the punt team again. Oh.
Josh Jones just had it slip right out at the last second.
He almost one-handed that.
Almost an amazing interception right there. The defensive line got tremendous pressure too. I think it was Dirtz, I believe. Or no. Was it Blaine Jordan had an insane spin move there on the interior?
Maybe if Josh had some gloves on, he could have got that one.
Yeah. Maybe.
Ty makes the first guy miss, and then some, bringing it up to the 50-yard line for the Dewhawks.
I mean, a good way to get embarrassed is trying to tackle Ty Bosch.
Yeah.
He might be the most untackable person.
He's got that quick footwork.
Yeah. The pitter-patter, the change of speed.
Oh, Dewhawks got two quarterbacks in right now. Devin Moore and Noah Sigworth. Well, this is a new look.
We're bringing out every trick in the book so far.
Why not? Devin Moore and Sigworth in the backfield together. Devin gets the snap. Dumps off to Sigworth. Running through a guy.
Wow.
Sigworth letting him know he came to play today.
Wow.
He just ran through number 22, Zach Olson, a senior.
He ran through 6 foot 185, so.
I mean, Sigworth, yeah. Come on now.
Nothing to squint at right there.
Dewhawks going to keep this same personnel in the field. Sigworth motions out to wide receiver. Devin motioning Sigworth in motion. Hands it off, fakes the handoff, and Sigworth got lit up on that one.
Yes.
And Sigworth's loving it.
That right there is why you always see two quarterbacks on the field at once, because one of them's going to get lit up.
Devin kept it in. Devin's not really known for his mobile presence in the pocket, really. He's more of a pocket passer.
After his multiple leg surgeries, he's had to become more of a pocket presence.
Yeah. Sigworth lined up at halfback. Devin dropping back, looking to air it out to Ty. Gets Ty. Ty making a man miss. Ty keeps his legs turning. Bring it to the 15-yard line.
There we go.
Good. That was a good ball there by Devin to Ty.
I like this two quarterback off.
It's actually working pretty well.
Sean Payton should be taking notes or
somebody.
Yeah, for Taysom Hill. And now Winston's out. It's Trevor Siemian.
Yeah.
So
Devin alone in the backfield, motioning Sigworth over. Sigworth now lined up at halfback. Devin pitches it to Sigworth. Sigworth throwing it, gets it to Ty. Ty brought down fairly close to the first down marker. And it looks like they're going to give it to him.
I mean, this might be the most unstoppable offense.
Honestly. Do you think Sigworth talked to Coach H before the game and said he wanted to, line up at halfback or wide receiver?
I would not be surprised if he did some asking for the coaches to do that. But Devin looked nice that
drive, he did.
Too. Yeah.
And I believe Devin's out of the game now.
Yeah.
Dewhawks back to their regular personnel. Sigworth alone in the backfield. Eli motioned. Sigworth looking around the pocket, looking to air it out in the back of the end zone. And touchdown, Dewhawks. Put it on the board.
Dwayne again?
The Dewhawks are just looking unstoppable right now on offense.
Yeah, they're a juggernaut right now on offense.
And like we said earlier, Sigworth's had a lot more presence in the pocket this game than pass, not trying to scramble out or do any of that stuff.
All right, now's the time. Now's the time. Oh.
Sigworth and Farfan.
Come on.
In the backfield. Oh! Sigworth keeps it!
Oh,
and walks it in for two!
That was so easy.
That was
we should do that every time.
Very easy. The Dewhawks now have a 3-touchdown lead here.
I mean, I think he might have, let's see, I think.
As we see the replay of the touchdown, Dwayne just found the soft spot in that zone and.
Yeah.
Took it in for the touchdown.
Good throw by Siggy right there. And I think on that two-point conversion, the defender fell for the fake, the pitcher far fan, which you can't do. You gotta make Siggy pitch that ball every single time if you're the defender right there.
Three drafts for the Duhawks, three touchdowns. I'd say that's 100%. You gotta be happy with that,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I don't think they can be upset with that at all.
No.
I mean, it's already the third time we're seeing Talbot out in the so that's good.
And we know how much you love Talbot.
Yeah.
Touchback Talbot, as you like to call
Touchback
him.
Touchback Talbot himself.
Sean's getting hyped there on the sideline. He's loving it.
Yeah.
As the Norse bring out their kick return team.
So as the Norse, like I said, I'll try to work in some play action, see if we can get one of these corners, the safeties, the bite on the fake, and maybe try some wide receiver screens, something quick so your quarterback's not
some
getting
misdirection stuff
lit up
that,
either.
Because the Duhawks have almost had, seems like, 8-7 guys in the box so far.
Yeah.
Talbot's kick is up, and the Norse are going to fair catch this one. And this Duhawk defense has looked unstoppable so far as well.
I think Talbot's going to have a nice day kicking. I think he's going to have to run out there quite a bit.
Mm-hmm. And then second quarter is going to be flipped. The wind's going to be at his back, too.
Yeah.
We're going to see some touchbacks.
Yeah, he might kick it out of the end zone.
No. Maybe kick it through the goalpost.
Will he kick it across the river? That is the question.
That is the question. Do you think he could?
On the right day,
The wind's strong enough.
Yeah.
Griffith in the backfield with Brooks. They hand it off to Brooks. Brooks got nowhere to go.
Just chased down there from the backside by Brett McWilliams. Left him unblocked, which is a good strategy.
Brooks really pushed that one outside, too.
Yeah. Mack just ran right down the line, made the tackle. Great job right there.
Brett McWilliams. 6:55 and counting here to go in this first quarter, which has had a lot of offense.
Yeah.
If this keeps up, I mean, Duhawks going to put up 80. Wouldn't that be something?
Yeah, that would be something on senior day.
Maybe even 100. Why not? The Norse send a man in motion. Griffith going to keep it. Not keep it. He's going to pass it. And then that one was almost picked by no other than, I believe, that was Josh Jones
again.
Once again.
Yeah.
Get that man some gloves.
He's almost had two picks. Right there. He would have had like a Willie Mays interception right there. His back turned.
Would have been something.
Yeah.
And then why not take it to the house? Maybe pitch it or something? This Luther Norse team is, they've struggled on offense, like EJ said, and they've had some struggles at quarterback. This is their third-string quarterback. They've had a lot of guys go down to injury. And last week when they played Central, I heard a lot of guys got injured.
Yeah.
As the Norse drop back to throw it, this ball's up, and that's a wobbler. And bringing up fourth down here for the Norse, once again, it's a quick three and out.
And he got hit again, this time sandwiched by Sam Jones and Brett McWilliams. That's a Wilmington sandwich right there. Pride of Wilmington, Illinois.
Speaking of sandwiches, EJ, I hear you're not a fan of ketchup.
Hugh, ketchup is the worst thing in the world, I think. I hate ketchup with my whole heart.
That's just, I don't know about that.
The St. Louis Cardinals and ketchup, those are my top two.
I can agree with the St. Louis Cardinals. Oh. As that punt is almost blocked by the Duhawks. Ty's going to fair catch that one.
I'm surprised it didn't throw a penalty flag. It looked like he didn't block it, but I'm pretty sure he made contact with the punter. So the punter is saying a little something to him, too.
Maybe because he was making a play on the ball, maybe.
Yeah, I'm not quite too sure.
But the Luther on third downs this season, 46 for 140. That's a 32% conversion rate.
That's not going to get done.
No, that's awesome. That's a lot of third downs. As Sigurd dropping back, QB draw, and he takes it for gaining around 2 yards.
Not a lot converted either. You know what? Feeling this possession, you know? Feeling
touchdown?
I'm feeling Monty might get loose.
Oh, okay.
Take one to the house.
Monty's back after he was out for a couple games with a concussion. Glad to see the star freshman back in there for the Duhawks. As we hand that one off to Eli, who gets a gain of around a yard.
I mean, the talk around Monty from all of the seniors and captains on his team is they all think he's going to be maybe the greatest receiver that Loras has seen. They think his potential is just off the charts. Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's shown, too. And then when he went out that concussion, it really hurt the Duhawk offense.
Yeah.
Sigworth and Eli in pistol formation. Sigworth dropping back. Pushed out of the pocket. Sigworth's going to keep it for himself as there's a flag on the play. Sigworth staying on his feet as he is hit. After the first down, and there's a flag on the play.
I think Matt Canda is injured on the play.
Looks like he's holding his hamstring or his knee. As we get to call in here from our head official.
Offense number 79. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Third down. Timeout. For an injured player.
Hopefully he's all right.
Holding on the Duhawks, number 79, Mitchell Husanga, the junior, out of Washington, Iowa.
What do you know about Washington, Iowa, Hugh?
I want to say it's like kind of by where I grew up. I want to say where I went to high school.
Okay.
I think there's a Washington, Iowa. I don't know if there's more than one or not.
Well, that's your report on Washington, Iowa.
Yeah, so yeah, Washington, Iowa. I think it's by where I went to high school.
Good to see him walking off. Slight limp. Doesn't look too bad, though.
Hopefully he's able to get back into this one.
Yep.
That holding penalty really set the Duhawks back as it's now 3rd and 18.
Now's a perfect time for Monty to run deep.
Cabrin Cook.
Yeah, he's back
out there, back.
Another deep threat.
Yeah. As he went out, I believe, first game of the year? Or won the first? Or the couple first?
Yeah, it was like first or second
game.
Yeah,
went over the middle and he got hit pretty hard or something like that. Yeah. Glad to see him back out there. Sigworth and Eli in the pistol formation. Sigworth dropping back, airing it out to Javon. He's got him. Javon staying on his feet. Brought down after a big gain for the Duhawks.
Yeah. Wow. Found the hole. That was
Sigworth looked nice so far in today's game.
Tough spot to fade in, but he did.
And Javon's a sophomore, and last year he only had about two games, but he was looking good as they jump it off to Eli. Eli using that speed to get through. He's brought down with the touchdown-saving tackle by the Norse.
The Norse tackling also has not been too great this year. Mm-hmm. I feel like there's been two or three guys needed to bring down the ball carry every time.
Yeah, as we saw from that run from Ty, took it 60 yards there.
Yeah.
Sigworth giving up to Monty. Monty high points that ball.
I told you.
Put it on the board. 6 for the Duhawks.
I mean, I think we could do that every time on the goal line, and it might be a touchdown every single time.
I mean, this is just an offensive explosion for the Duhawks.
Yeah. This is, I think, the greatest quarter I've seen. Oh, we've had some great celebrations.
Breaking
tonight.
It down over there. Far fans out to kick this extra point 1-for-2 on the day. This one is up, and it is good. Getting the Duhawks a 28-0 lead here with 4:40 to go in the first. As you see that, Sigworth just knew who he had out there and expected Monty to go up and get that ball. And like you said, Monty's potential's off the charts and is just showing how he can high point a ball like that right there.
Yeah, he was going against the 5'9", 170 junior, so he had the height advantage for sure. It's evident right there.
And Monty's just always a threat out there for a touchdown.
Absolutely.
Talbot's out to kick it for the fourth time.
In the first
quarter. Yeah. We still got 4:40 left to play. We could score again. If this game does get out of hand, is Coach H going to keep the seniors in there? Or what do you think?
That's what I was trying to think about. I don't know. I have to imagine at some point he'd probably call off the first string.
Maybe fourth quarter, do you think?
Yeah,
I think it'd be the third quarter if this
scoring
keeps
depends,
up.
It depends if this keeps up. If we're going to score every possession, it's going to be before that.
Talbot's kick is away, and the Norse are going to fair catch this one. this crowd for the offensive explosions haven't really gotten into it too much.
Yeah, pretty silent crowd today.
And, EJ, I know you like your defense, but what about this offense for the Duhawks?
I mean, they're just looking unstoppable so far. Siggy's firing all cylinders. Offensive line's looking good. Running backs look good. We just looked bigger, faster, stronger, and, like, we wanted it more. This Norse defense has almost looked like kind of waving the towel at some place.
Yeah. As they're back, as the Norse are back there, alone in the backfield, hands it off to his running back, Brooks, who goes nowhere for the Norse.
I mean, the defensive line's just been all over the running back today.
He's had nowhere to go. And I believe we've only seen the Rashawn Brooks for the Norse as well.
Yeah.
I haven't seen anybody else.
I've not seen any Evan Porter. Both freshmen for running backs.
As the Norse handed off to Brooks again, who goes nowhere. This Duhawk defense swarming on everything.
Oh, a little tempo here from the Norse.
I mean, you gotta figure out something here.
Yeah.
Griffith alone in the backfield. Quick drop back, looking to get out to his wide receiver. Joey Foley on the coverage there, breaking that one up.
Yeah, great break on the ball right there with Joey.
Intended target looks like it was number 6. Parker Kaiser, a senior out of Palmer, Alaska.
Wow.
Yeah.
How did you get...
The Norse must have some amazing recruiting out there in Alaska.
Wow.
I mean, the temperature's not too different. It might actually be warmer here.
Oh, it's definitely warmer here.
Oh, that punt is almost blocked. That's a beautiful punt.
Yeah, we're going to block one of these.
Ty gets it. Oh, it's not Ty. That's Jace.
No, I think that's the freshman.
Number 5?
Yeah.
We have double number?
Yeah.
Oh.
Jake Rockweiler.
Yeah. Out of Elkhorn, Wisconsin. These double numbers, always tricky.
Yeah, yeah.
Looks like your roommate, Michael Crawford's in the game.
Yep, the man himself.
Sigworth. Takes the handoff to Ty.
Oh.
Sigworth, that ball is a little high and behind Monty over the middle.
Yeah, that's a
risky ball.
That was a dangerous throw for Monty right there. He would have caught it. He got lit up right in his back.
If you would have hit him in stride, Monty could have cut that one up and almost looked like it would have been a touchdown.
Yeah, I would not have been surprised if we were seeing him dancing on the sideline right about now.
Maybe hit the gritty or something?
Yeah.
How's your gritty, EJ?
Well, I can't really dance at all, so I like the classic, this minimal movement.
As they dump it off to his running back, who gets a gain pretty close to the first down, and that was Raddick.
Good to see him get some touches.
Mm-hmm. A guy whose name we haven't really called so far this season. Glad to see him getting that chance on senior day.
Yeah, I think he was concussed at the beginning of the year, and then he's come back. We see him call his name a little bit this year. I think he scored one or two touchdowns.
But most of that workload's given up to Ty or Eli.
Yeah. Rag's much more classic in between the tackles, running back, where Ty and Eli a little faster.
Sigworth on the read option gives it up and might not have been the right choice there. As that brings up fourth down for the Duhawks, and they're a little bit no man's land. Looks like they're going to go for it.
I mean, I would too. Honestly, if higher defense playing, I don't think Norse are going to be able to move the ball much. So
yeah. Sigworth in the pistol formation. Rack in the backfield. Monty Brown at the bottom of your screen. Next to him is Javon Williams. 10 seconds on the play clock here. Sigworth looking to get the play in. Looks like the Norse are going to bring some pressure. Giving up to Monty Brown. Monty Brown wide open. Goes the wrong way. Getting it close to the first down. Let's see if the refs give it to him.
Oh, he got it, yep.
Little sketchy there when he started to go the other way, but good job by him making that play to get it. Sigworth jumped to Raddick. Raddick with the ninja headband taking it out of bounds.
The ninja headbands are sick.
Mm-hmm.
They, I swear, they give you like +5 speed.
It's a shame the NBA had to ban them.
Yeah, yeah, they're so cool.
Mm-hmm.
Might have to invest in one actually. Now
for basketball,
yeah.
For intramurals.
Yeah.
If we're lucky enough to have them this year.
I hope so.
Got a three bunch here at the bottom of your screen for the Duhawks. Sigwart alone in the backfield. Drop him back. Oh, he's got Crawford wide open, and he overthrows him. Oh, you would have loved that, wouldn't you, VJ?
Yeah,
your
just,
roommate.
Is this Crawford and the turf. Mm-hmm. That's all that was there.
I mean, he was just wide open, just ran a straight post in.
Yep.
Ran a straight post in, man. This Duhawk offense almost hurting themselves here. That's really been their biggest defenses themselves
yeah.
so far.
Yeah.
Looks like Monty Brown's got man coverage with a little safety help, maybe. No, he's got no safety help. Sigwart's going to keep it. Making a couple moves, the first down and then some. Sigworth staying on his feet. Sigworth, beast mode, who?
Wow.
Sigworth looking a little bit like prime Marshawn Lynch.
Yeah. That was, what a run right there by the leader of the offense.
I mean, just throwing guys off him. It's always fun to see guys just get tossed around out there by the quarterback of nobody else.
See, you doing it all today.
Yeah. Sigworth and Ty checks back into the game for the Duhawks. Eli out wide. Motion's over. Sigworth keeps it and gets little gain. I had to wait to see who got that one because I couldn't tell.
Yeah, I was very confused also. Will the Duhawks score before the end of the first quarter?
I think they can do it. I think they can do it. I wonder what the record is for the Duhawks with most points in a quarter because they score here. I feel like they got to be close to it.
Yeah.
Sigworth hands that one off to Ty. Ty keeps those legs going. And he's brought down short of the goal line.
Run up the middle, down number
22 seconds left to go here in this first quarter. And is Coach H going to run another play here or no, EJ?
It looks like they're getting their subs on the field. So, yeah. Now Siggy's walking away. Never mind. Of course, right when I say they're about to.
Right when you're making your next prediction, they just wanted to prove you wrong.
Yep.
You've just been too good at it.
They're listening to the live stream. They're like, oh, we got to change it.
At the end of the first quarter, your Loras College Duhawks 28 and Luther North 0. And I believe our sideline man, Cade Messer, has got something for us. Cade, what do you got for us?
Hey guys, what a big first half big first quarter it was there for the Duhawks. After 15 minutes of football, they're up 28-0. I've been listening into this lower sideline. They're saying keep the foot on the gas, don't give up yet, keep the momentum on our sideline. Look out for that here in the second quarter as the Duhawks trying to extend their lead. Back up to you guys.
Awesome, thank you, Cade. Once again, just these great insights from Cade.
Yeah.
I'm loving it down there.
He's absolutely dripped out.
He is.
The fit goes hard.
I like it. I bet you he tied his own tie, too.
Yeah.
I couldn't do that, honestly.
I cannot tie
my own tie.
For
every school dance in high school, my dad had to tie it for me.
Gotcha. I mean, I learned to because we were supposed to wear them at school every day.
Mm.
Not well. I cannot do it well, but I can get the job done.
Yeah, yeah. And then when I had to wear a bow tie for my sister's wedding, it was a clip-on.
Oh, gotcha.
Mm-hmm. And then when I was in band, I had to wear a clip-on and bow tie, too.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
I've never been a bow tie guy.
Oh, bow ties are where it's at, EJ.
I don't know, man.
What's wrong with the bow tie? They're nice, clean, spiffy.
I don't know. I just like, you know.
The long
tie? Nice tie.
Maybe,
yeah, you know?
Maybe add a little more drip to it with the tie clip.
Oh, yeah. You got to add the tie clip.
Otherwise, it'll be flying around everywhere.
Yeah.
Enough talk about ties as Sigworth and Eli are in the backfield.
What's this, Ty Bosch?
That would have been a great segue.
Yeah, too bad
he's not even on the field. Sigworth dropping back, quick drop back, dumps off to Eli in the flat, who is wide open, put it on the board, 6 for the Duhawks, as they're just running this one up.
Yeah, this Duhawk offense is not going to be stopped, though.
No.
By the Norse.
I mean, we're just on a roll.
The only way that we could be stopped is penalties or just like the overthrow we had,
mm-hmm.
like you said.
The Duhawks have 176 rushing yards so far.
And the Norse have eight as Farfan's kick is up, and there's a flag on the play. The refs are gonna say it's good. They're questioning each other. Yeah, yep, they're going to say it's good, but there's a flag on the play. As we wait to get the call here from the refs. Must be on Luther as both teams are walking off.
There's no foul on the play.
Nope, no foul. Refs got a little happy there with the flag on the sideline. Did you see the replay of this last touchdown scoring play? Nobody just took Eli. Eli was wide open and took it in for six.
Too easy.
No dance moves this time, though, sadly.
Andre Atkins right now is two targets with one catch for 1 yard, but negative five after the catch, so not looking good.
Yeah, they have one passing yard, I believe.
Yeah, they're one for eight for one passing yard.
And eight rushing yards, so their total offense is 9 yards?
They have not gathered enough total offense for a first down.
Yeah. And they have one first down. That's due to a Duhok penalty.
Oh, correct.
A roughing the passer. The Duhoks have 11 first downs.
Wow.
Talbot's kick is up, and it is away. Oh, the wind died down right as we switched sides, too.
Wow.
They just don't want to see a touchback by Talbot. The Duhawks have 11 rushing attempts with 176 yards, averaging 16 yards a carry. That is just insane. Ty's got 78 yards.
Yeah, Ty and Eli are both averaging over 35 a carry. Siggy, 105, three touchdowns. Devin Moore also three, three.
105, yards. Three touchdowns. That's some quarterback's whole game right there.
Yeah.
And Siggy did that in one quarter. Well, he has another touchdown, too, so four touchdowns. Yeah. Griffith pushed out of the pocket. Knocked down by the Duhawks. Number 11 for the Duhawks.
Charlie Dawson, I believe. Or Dawson Charlie.
Yeah. Look at you. Don't even need the roster for it. Know this team by heart. We haven't really said his name a whole bunch this year.
Yeah, he's kind of
he's a junior.
Yeah, he's kind of the safety. He can play all three of the safety positions. Mm-hmm. He knows what to do.
And what are those three safety positions?
So you got the nickel, the strong, and the free. So the nickel is what Mason Morris usually plays.
Mm-hmm.
More of a, I don't know how to describe it, a lot more in the run game. You know, they blitz a lot more,
uh-huh.
Where the other two guys are more pass coverage all the time.
Yeah. Norris hand this one off to Brooks, who gets a gain of around 3 or 4 yards there for the Norse.
Run up the middle by number 29, Brooks.
And already third down.
This Duhawk defense is, they've been clamping all game. And this Luther Norse team, as their quarterback, it's their third string. He struggled a little bit with the accuracy. But he's got the measurables for a good quarterback.
Oh, absolutely.
6'6", 210, I mean. The future's bright for this kid.
Surprised you're not targeting Andre Atkins more.
Mm-hmm. Luther dropping back. He's hit as he throws it, and he is lit off.
He got absolutely
and he is hurt on that
smoked.
Play. Oh. Hit by Jack Foley.
Oh, no.
And he got lit up.
I take back what I said about Mason Morris being a heat-seeking missile. That was one of the hardest hits I've seen on a blitz. Wow. Hope he's all right.
Like, I didn't even watch the pass after that hit. I just saw the quarterback go down. It looked like his head, a little bit of whiplash at the turf.
Yeah, the pass was wobbling out of bounds, as you can imagine, after taking that hit.
Yeah. Jack Foley I believe that was Jack Foley.
It was.
Like we said earlier in the game, comes in on those blitzes sometimes, comes in untouched, like that play right there. He was untouched.
He might be the GOAT blitzing quarterback, just like any level anywhere.
Yeah.
He might be.
Yeah. Yeah, why not? I mean,
I've never seen a corner rack up this many tackles for a loss and sacks and like with big hits too. It's not like he's
more of a safety than a cornerback, honestly.
Yeah. It's not like he's doing
the way he plays.
Shoelace tackles.
No.
Is that number five? Is that Jace Gwynn out there on the sideline?
That would be Jace, I think.
Looks like he's got a ninja headband, too.
On the punt.
Must be a staple of the Stu Hawk team. As the quarterback there for the Norris Griffith is still getting worked on there by the training staff as he is up. And looks like he's got a towel on his face. Maybe he's bleeding a little bit.
Yeah, his head did not look like it went back there pretty good. Hopefully he's all right.
Yeah. And the backup quarterback for the Norris looks like it's number six, Parker Kaiser. But on the game day roster, it has him listed as a running back. But we're going to have to wait to find that out because it's fourth down for the Norris. And it looks like Jace is back there to receive it.
Jake Rockweiler.
Hmm?
Jake Rockweiler. Right? He's a returner.
Yeah, but you
time,
said
right?
That was Jay's out there.
Well, then I definitely lied. I definitely
lying
lied.
Lying to me after I was hyping you up about how... Ah, EJ. As he fair catches this one. And the Duhawks are going to trap back out there on offense. Sigworth in at quarterback. Ty coming in at halfback.
I kind of want to see the two quarterback offense again.
That was actually fun to watch.
That was an electric factory.
Almost like Scranton, Pennsylvania, the electric city. You a fan of The Office, EJ?
I am.
Yeah, you know what I'm talking
Who's
about.
Who's your favorite character?
It's got to be Dwight.
Dwight is
he's
I think
so
might,
funny.
I think
Him
Dwight.
And Jim have that great on camera personality as they hand this one off to Ty, and Ty goes nowhere. First time the Duhawks have really been stopped on offense. Yeah. The Norris are probably tired of getting run over and beat up on for a quarter.
Yeah. He said enough of that. But we'll see what happens this
year. Yeah. I mean, their cornerbacks have not really been able to guard our receivers out wide.
This is a great receiving core. Mm-hmm. We just have a little bit bigger and more physical receivers than their cornerbacks, it seems like.
Sigworth dropping back. He's got plenty of turf in front of him. He's going to run and cut this one back for the first down and then some. Sigworth picking up a big first down for the Duhawks.
Wow. Oh, no.
Looks like another Luther player is down on the field.
Another Norseman.
Mm-hmm.
First down,
Laura. Looked like it was number, I don't know, number that was that 19?
Yeah, something.
Number 19, Dexter Wright, the freshman out of Cottage Grove, Minnesota. A lot of freshmen on this Luther team as well.
Yeah, very young team.
Which could be part of their struggles so far this year, 0-9.
110%.
And the Luther coach in his career, Caleb Fidel, is 2-29. For his career so far at coaching.
That's not what
as
we
a
want.
Head coach. No, that's not what you want.
Do we know who the two victories are against?
We do not. No. Yeah.
Maybe who is it? I was just thinking about Simpson? Not this year, but in years past.
Yeah. As he's able to As Dexter Wright's able to get up off the field, but he is getting a little assistance, and hopefully he's okay and able to come back into this game.
I mean, this has been a brutal game for
it
them.
Has
like
been.
Three or four injuries.
Down 35, nothing with 13 left to go in the half.
In the first half, too. Nice.
I mean, they got a pretty big crowd over there right in front of Roland Hall, too. I think that's the biggest away crowd I've seen all year.
Yeah.
Sigworth, quick screen pass out to Cabrin Cook. Cabrin gets the first down.
Good to see him get a touch. Mm-hmm. Oh, no.
As another Luther player's down.
He's got it, though.
As his teammate pulls him up and says, you're fine.
And he's like,
we can't have another guy go down.
We're going to have to start offensive players coming in.
That was number 95, Levi Walter, the junior from Eleeson, Minnesota. Sigworth and Ty, pistol formation. Sigworth, three-step drop back. Push up in the pocket. He's got Mike McDevitt,
yep.
I believe.
Yep, that was McDevitt.
For the first down.
Good catch, too.
Yeah, led him pretty good, too.
Good to see the senior getting some touches.
Mike McDevitt and Hunter Machi have the same build, and it's kind of hard, but now that I see Hunter Machi out there, he's got the arm sleeve. That'll help me out.
Yeah, Machi's a little bigger. He's played tight end his whole career, so he's had that weight his whole life, so he probably weighs like 20 more pounds, where Mike has been a receiver, so he's had to try to gain a lot of weight.
Ooh, Monty Brown, single coverage out there.
I like that matchup.
Sigworth's going to keep it. And are they going to give it to him? I think he got it, but
it looked like he fell in, but they're saying he's down at the one. I think they should throw up to Monty because
why not get a highlight reel?
Cool plays. Yeah.
I mean, maybe it was a good enough play. Maybe submit it to, you know, SportsCenter Top 10 or something.
Or give it to a senior here, maybe, you know. Give it to Machi or McDevitt.
Luther, they're really stacking that front line right now. As Eli's in motion, they hand off to Ty, and Ty goes nowhere.
All right, Luther.
Looks like Ty lost the yard there.
Seen some life on this goal line now.
I mean, I wouldn't know firsthand, but I'd assume defensive guys have a lot of pride, especially when they're getting scored on by this much.
Yeah. Absolutely, yeah, it's definitely turns.
Have you ever been a part of a game like this, EJ, on defense, where your team was getting scored on?
No.
You're just that big of an X factor out there.
I feel like in high school and middle school, you're always one of the better
teams.
Those
games are always, Sigworth's going to keep it.
No one.
Easy walk-in touchdown. Put it on the board for the Duhawks. And this is just getting out of hand so far in this first half.
That was easy on the read option right there.
It was. Duhawks going to dump this one off to Farfan?
I hope so. See, 17 Julio Garza right there just fell for the fake.
And you almost got a... hope that Sigworth hands it out. Oh, they are. Oh, give it to Farfan. Oh, Sigworth's going to keep it again. I think they're looking to give it to Farfan. Yeah, and that's why they keep doing this.
Yeah.
I think it would be, as we see the replay of this touchdown, this walk-in touchdown. Luther just bit on that run, and Sigworth too quick to get touched there.
Yeah. And like we said, in that two-point conversion right there, you have to make Siggy pitch that. There's no way you can let Siggy. We know he's a runner. You know he's a great runner. Versus Farfan, who, let's see, what is Farfan's measurements?
Small.
That is true. But his official, what's his number?
I think it's
33, yep. He is 5'8", 160. You gotta try to make 5'8", 160 cross the goal line.
Compared to...
like 6'2", 210?
Yeah, 6'2", 210. Exactly. Whoa, EJ.
Hey,
look at you.
I saw it earlier in the game.
As Talbot's out to kick this one away again, and the Duhawks don't score again this first half. They're on pace for 86 points.
And there's still 10 minutes
left. Wow. Hey, maybe we do see 100.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that be something? Yeah.
Well, I think we're going
to... me and you get a call that game.
I think we're going to see the freshman quarterbacks get in before that point. Mm-hmm.
The other quarterbacks on this Duhawk roster, looking forward, is number 10, Garrett Hutchison, a sophomore out of Des Moines, Iowa. I know where that one is.
Yeah, I would hope so.
Evan Ingold, or is that England? Evan Ingold, the quarterback. He's 6'2", 185, a freshman out of Wheaton, Illinois. Number 16, Nate Helms, 6'1", 175, freshman out of Morrison, Illinois. EJ, you know where that is?
I do not.
And then number 17, Trevor Shishow. As Luther is going to keep this one. Oh, he's hit hard by the Duhawk defense. Different quarterback. Looks like.
Yeah, Parker Kaiser, number 6.
And they have him listed as a running back on our roster here.
Maybe we're going to see a lot more of plays like
Wildcat.
That.
Wildcat.
Yeah, one quarterback we did miss in our freshman, Max Lombowski out of Monroe, Wisconsin, 6'3", 180.
We had a lot of freshman quarterbacks out here.
Lots of them.
And I assume Devin will probably come in for a little bit as well if Sigworth does come out of this game. And then is there a chain of command for substitutions in games like this, like sophomores, juniors? Or
I think it's just whoever's the next best guy. So After Devin, I cannot tell you who would be going in.
I remember the one game we did last year. I believe Garrett came in for a couple plays.
Yeah. Well, that's just because we were out because Sweezal was playing on a torn ACL. Siggy was hurt. And I think Garrett was the only other option.
Mm-hmm. No, last year is when we were played that Minnesota team, remember? And we won by a lot. I think it's just because Sigrid just.
Oh, I must have been thinking 2 years ago then.
I wasn't here 2 years ago.
Dude, I could have sworn that Sweezal played on the torn ACL last year, though.
I'm pretty sure he came in for a little bit, though. Or another quarterback came in before Garrett, but that was a while ago.
Maybe all they needed was Parker Kaiser coming in.
Yeah.
Moving the chain.
Second first down of the game.
First
one not because of a penalty.
I can confirm when you asked the whereabouts of where Morrison, Illinois is, it's west of Rock Falls on Rock Falls on Route 30 for all the Illinois people out there.
I don't know where that is. As the Norris hand this one off, and he's got a little bit of room. As he runs into his own guy, stays on his feet as the Duhawks, I believe, lost a helmet.
All right.
Is that Za? Zacchaeus Knighton.
And everyone's hyping him up. Let's go, Za.
And EJ, you got to do a piece for Do Media. You got to do a piece with Zacchaeus and President Jim Collins.
It was a lot of fun. Those guys are hilarious together. They have a great relationship.
You got to do it for your segment on YouTube, Generation Game.
Yes.
Want to tell us a little bit about that?
Thank you for the plug.
Yeah, hey, you want to tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, it's just a trivia game where we take one Loras faculty versus one Loras student and we quiz them on each other's era. It's been a lot of fun. And
yeah. They've turned out really nice, too.
Thank you.
Go check them out on YouTube, Do Media. As the Duhawks defense making a big stop there.
Sam Jones. The Norris have tried that a couple times now where they leave the backside unblocked and the Loras DNs have just done a great job going right down the line, chasing it down. On those plays, it's all about motor and staying on your line.
You think Luther's going to throw this ball here with this quarterback in? Or?
Well, I don't know. Well, let's see what his arm's like. Maybe a screen, I'd have to imagine.
Luther.
Nope.
QB keeper. Picks up the first. Ooh. Looks like that far line judge marked him a little short. Bring up fourth down. Good stop there by the Duhawk defense.
Yeah. They're going to have to change their game plan now. Kaiser's in the complete differences. If you see, I do not think he's going to throw the ball unless he absolutely has to.
QB keeper needs to pick up around a yard. And oh, he lost the ball.
I think they said he was down.
Yeah, it looks like the fairly close by where that ref is, but I think he's a little short by where that far line judge is located at. Trying to get the right angle from our view here.
He is.
Huge stop for the Duhawk defense on fourth down.
What a stop. I'm surprised I thought for sure he was going to get it.
Bring out the stop troops, and they did just that.
Devin Moore's in now.
Ooh. Two QB offense like you were asking for.
Oh, let's go.
Coach Alminiak heard you, EJ.
Yeah. Coach Olson, actually, the coordinator. Oh.
Look at you. Does he call the plays? Or
yeah.
He does.
Coach H is O-line.
Oh, okay. Oh, little trickery. Oh, Devin's airing it out to tie. Oh, throw the flag. Ow.
I think if the ball was inbounds, they might have thrown it, but was it catchable? That's what we like to see, though.
That was. Bring a little life to this game.
Maybe the Monty, though. I know.
Monty might have.
Yeah. Ty's not really the best
speed-wise.
Go up and get it type guy, you know. He's a more catch it 5 yards and then take it 80, you know.
For sure. As Sigworth is lined up out wide, the bottom of your screen there on the 50 in the three bunch. Dwayne in motion. Devin hands it off to Ty, who hands off to Sigworth. Sigworth looking to air it out. He's got Dwayne. Dwayne's covered, and that one's thrown out of bounds as well. That play really had nowhere to go from that, from the start.
I thought for sure Siggy's going to get lit up right there.
Yeah.
But
almost like the defender kind of slowed down when he got by Sigworth.
Yeah. These plays have been 10 out of 10 cool, but they have not been.
No conversion so far on it. Looks like Ty's a little hobble on the sideline with a limp. Devin and Sigworth alone Not alone backfielder in pistol formation together. Devin, the lefty, dropping back, airing it out. Gets the first down. I believe Marty. That's Marty McGovern. I believe that's his first or second catch of the game.
Second, yeah, he had that little comeback in the first quarter. St. Pat's High School won last night, too.
Oh.
Marty McGovern and Michael Crawford's High School. And if my high school, Boylan Catholic, wins today, they will play St. Pat's.
Oh. So. Are they big rivals, St. Pat's and Boylan?
No.
Sigworth hands this one off to Eli. Eli trying to bounce that one to the outside, keeps those legs turning.
I think they should run a two-quarterback offense on the goal line
mm-hmm.
and have Devin lined up wide and throw it up to him.
Oh, that
would be. Who's going to stop him when
yeah.
in the air? All these cornerbacks
6'4",
are way. 6'4",
225.
Yeah. All these cornerbacks are way smaller than him.
Duhawks hand this one off, and Dwayne motioning for a first down, but he's a yard or two short.
Yeah, well short.
Brought down at the 21-yard line, brings up third down.
Cabron Cook lined out wide for the Duhawks this play.
Two tight ends here.
Both the big tight ends. Mike McDevitt, Hunter Monchi, Dwayne, both receivers at the top of your screen. Cabron moves in motion. Cabron motions again. Sigworth fakes it to him. He's got the option to pitch it. He keeps it for himself and gets the first down and then some.
The double motion right there.
Yeah. Almost thought Sigworth was going to pitch that one for a little bit there when he was about to get tackled. Good job by him picking up that first down, knowing where the sticks were. Javon checks back in here for the Duhawks as Hunter Machi comes out.
We haven't seen any of a Niner Harrison Willis
so
far.
No, we haven't.
It's all been Dwayne and Javon in the slot.
Sigworth on the read option. Keeps it. Fakes like he's going to run it. Sigworth. Good block by Dwayne. Oh, they're going to call a hold.
If he would have
let go
like at the end mm-hmm. there. Great run, though, by
Sigworth. Yeah, it was.
He's so fast.
Mm-hmm.
He's so fast.
Yeah. And just before that play, you mentioned the slot receiver. What do those slot receivers offer compared to, say, those other wide receivers out wide?
So the slot guys are more like the shorter, quick guys who mm-hmm. are going to catch like a 5-yard pass and take it to the house 80 yards. Mm-hmm. They're not going to be the guys who are going to run deep down the field always, but they will so occasionally, but mm-hmm. that's where it would be Cabron and Imani.
Yeah.
And you're not going to really throw them too many jump balls either, like Cabron and Imani.
Mm-hmm. A little bit of the dirty work, guys.
Yeah.
Would you say?
Yeah.
Sigworth, quick drop back. Gets it to Javon over the middle. Javon, it's a nice gain there for the first down. Speaking of the slot, there he is.
They run a lot of those little snag routes. Mm-hmm. So, you know, they're very aware of where their sticks are, and that's where their route goes to.
It was a good job by Javon. The ball was a little behind him, and he went up and got over the middle. Sigworth hands this one off to Eli. Eli met right away and does a good job of only losing around half a yard there.
There's Harrison checking in. Good old number 9.
Looking for a touchdown out of him?
Hopefully.
Sigworth with Eli in the backfield. Sigworth hands this one off to Eli. Eli's going to go in untouched. Put it on the board for the Duhawks.
3 touchdowns for Eli already.
That's a hat trick in the first half.
50.
If
we make
if
this.
We get this.
We can't jinx it.
Knock on wood.
Because I knock on you, sir.
Hey, maybe we'll see Farfan running in for 2 here.
Or do a direct snap and have him throw it to Machi.
That would be. Oh. Wow. They just want to get that 50 for the first half. As you called a 50 burger, I believe.
Yeah. Nice 50 burger. First half 50 burger,
mm-hmm.
too. Those ones always taste a little better.
Especially with ketchup on it, right?
No. If there's ketchup. So when I forget to say no ketchup, I will be so upset myself, either I won't eat it or I'll take a napkin as usual do it and wipe every single remnant of ketchup off.
What's the bad experience you've had with ketchup that you don't like it so
much? It
just
tastes so bad. It's literally like the worst tasting thing ever.
Well, if I could say that about mustard.
Well, didn't you just be wrong?
Oh, okay. Maybe a little bias coming out of you there.
No. That's just facts here.
Okay. Far fans longer, extra point is up, and it is good. Giving the Duhawks a 50-0 lead here in the first half.
Yeah, this is a 50 burger, no catch up for sure.
Let's see the replay here. Sigworth, they bit on that read, and Eli just used that great speed he has and took that one in for six.
He's completely untouched on the outside. Yeah. A wall of Duhawks protecting them right there.
And our O lines looked very good so far in today's game.
This is the best I think the O lines looked all year. They're playing great.
They've struggled a little bit throughout the year.
The last couple of weeks, though, they haven't looked too bad. Last games we've done, they've started to get better.
As we see that offensive line right there on your screen.
The men in the trenches.
Yeah, battling out there.
And the tight ends. Doing all the dirty work.
Mm-hmm.
A line doesn't get enough love here, you know?
Yeah, we got to show them love. Mm-hmm. Back in my days, around like fourth, sixth grade, I was a lineman.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Guard, center, tackle?
I was a guard. Nice. They put me everywhere on the line. I'm just that versatile, you know.
In high school, I was O-line and D-line.
Would you play tackle?
Yeah.
Yeah? I can see it with how tall you are.
Yeah, but I weighed like 195 pounds, so it's the skinniest tackle of all time.
Luther, he can't fair catch that one after he touched it.
Oh,
gosh. The Luther's day just gets worse and worse.
Wow, I thought it was about to roll out of bounds right there.
Yeah. Talbot kind of had a little bit of spin on that kick, too.
All we need is a Jack Foley pick six, and it's senior day. That would be a great senior day.
Would you prefer a Jack or a Joey pick six?
You can't do this. I guess it's senior day, so I got to go with Jack. Joey's going to have more opportunities next year.
Were you the last game we had, I know you weren't here for it. How did you feel when Joey had that score?
I thought that was a very selfish move by him to score when I'm not there. It was a very bad friend move.
Did you let him know?
I did, and he agreed.
Okay.
He's like, I should have waited. That's the game.
Maybe he'll get one today's game, too. It's a low snap there for Luther, and oh, Lord. He goes nowhere after that loss of around 2 yards.
Someone lost their hat. Dirtz.
And Dirtz is a very strong guy.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Always pumping that iron in the weight room.
You know how he got that strong?
How?
Never ate ketchup.
Why don't we ask him?
I actually don't know. Yeah. I actually cannot confirm or deny his stance on ketchup.
Can you confirm or deny anybody else's stance on ketchup in the field?
Jack Foley, known ketchup hater.
Oh,
but
what about
Joey Foley? Like maybe the biggest ketchup fan of all time.
Bigger than Patrick Mahomes?
Probably not.
As the Luther hands this one off, and keeping those legs turning, it's the best run they've had all day.
Yeah,
look pretty good right there, actually.
Yeah. I just realized, talking about pick six, don't think we're going to see too many more passes.
That's true. Going to turn into like a little bit of an Army-Navy game here with these guys. Nothing but runs.
I was thinking about that. Like, if you're a wide receiver, why would you go to either of those schools? Like,
yeah.
I understand if you want to join the Army or Navy, then like I feel like playing football as a receiver.
Yeah, for Army, especially them.
Blocking that every single play. Like,
yeah, it's always fun to watch the Army-Navy game, but just a lot of runs.
Yeah. Oh, Army Navy is sick, though.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Luther getting first down. Pretty close, getting to 10 yards there as Brett Bauer shoves Brooks out of bounds.
Showing some life here.
I mean, we got to kind of want that first half shutout, though.
Yeah, absolutely. We want the
maybe a full-time game. We want a full game shutout. Yeah.
You know Coach Bauer wants it.
Think Coach Bauer do anything special if they get a full-game shutout or no?
Might give some more extra high fives.
No pizza or nothing.
No.
Not bringing any incentives.
I would not. Think so.
Luther, QB keeper, trying to make a couple guys miss, and almost got back to the original line of scrimmage, but he's brought down as more Duhawks got there. I believe Josh Jones was the first one to meet him.
Yeah, a plethora of Duhawks coming in for finishing up the tackle right there.
Tackled by number 63, Thomas Wellborn, and number 3, Brett Bauer. Ball spotted at the 26-yard line.
We might have Matt Luke out there on the D-line for the Duhawks, the freshman. on the other side.
On the far side?
Yeah. I think it's the first time we've seen him get any action. Skyrim, or no, is that Ty? Like something? Ty Peoples? It's one of those two, I think.
As Luther runs it here, and oh, stays on his feet. Runs through.
Good run right there.
Runs through number 8 for the Duhawks. Patrick Suddy? Is that how you say it?
Yep, Suddy. Senior out of Wisconsin. Big Wisconsin fan.
Big Packer fan?
Packer.
Oh, yeah, Buck, I like to hear Buck, that.
University of Wisconsin.
Like to hear a Packer fan.
No.
You're a Bears fan, aren't you, EJ?
Oh, that's Suddy playing D-line. That's,
yeah, that's him.
I forgot he recently changed. He's a former safety. Then they changed
him. They have him listed at DB here. Sparta, Wisconsin.
That may be the coolest name of any town I've ever heard in my life.
That is such a cool name. As the Luther Norths hand this one off, and I believe that was Blaine Jordan making the stop there, gobbling him up. Bringing a fourth down for Luther. With a minute left to go here in the half, and unless the Duhawks return this kick for a touchdown, I don't know if we're going to be scoring again this half.
Yeah, yeah. I have to imagine they're probably going to hand the ball off.
Yeah. But Harrison back there returned the kick.
Yeah.
Make something happen. Luther's going to let this play clock run down all the way. It's at 8 seconds. 40 on the game clock. It looks like Luther's going to call a timeout instead of taking the delay of game.
So first timeout for either team so far.
Mm-hmm.
Don't see that too often. No. 35 seconds left in the half.
Some Seven Nation Army playing.
Always. That's a.
Does this get you hype, EJ?
Yeah, I mean, this has got to be a top 5 stadium song for this. Any stadium, yeah, you hear the song, you're always going to hear someone's going to hit the little hum, you know, and you stomp your feet, maybe, and nod your head. You know?
Yeah. Maybe you get these fans into it a little bit more. I haven't really been into this game a whole bunch.
Yeah.
Looks like they're all getting lined up at the concession stand for that halftime snack.
Yeah. Getting ready to go back out to a tailgate, maybe, too. Mm-hmm.
Getting the 2-thumbs-up pulled pork sandwich, probably.
Oh. Two thumbs up pulled pork sandwich is legit.
I bet you'd be better if there's ketchup on it.
Hugh. Hugh.
I just can't let you. Ooh.
Did they get a hand?
Maybe
on?
Got a hand on it. As that one trickles out of bounds on the Duhawk 45 yard line.
I thought Harrison was going to think about catching it right there.
Would the coaches be happy about that one?
No. So my freshman year, Michael Crawford did a similar thing in a JV game, and then he fumbled it. It would have been so cool if he didn't. He might have scored a touchdown if he didn't, but then he fumbled and they recovered. So, as you can imagine, coaches were not happy.
Day for him.
Yeah.
As Ty, is that Ty back in the backfield? I don't think it is. As they fake the handoff, looking to air it out at the end of the half, come to Marty McGovern. Sigworth underthrew him a little bit there, and 21 seconds left to go in this first half.
I definitely feel like that should have been an interception by number 3. I'm not sure why he didn't stick his arms out or dive. Absolutely could have been an interception.
Yeah, that is Eric Roddick in at the backfield there for the Duhawks. We got to hope Ty's okay, as we saw him on the sideline earlier in this quarter hobbling around.
His Farfan Talbot just missed the kicking that and almost nailed someone on the sideline.
Sigworth rolled out of the pocket, overthrows his big tight end, Mike McDevitt, almost got intercepted. Sigworth shaking that arm, maybe had a little bit of a stinger there. Bryce 16 seconds left to go here in this first half. Third down and 10 for the Duhawks on their own 45-yard line. Haven't moved the ball since taking over. Sigurd Raddick in the backfield. Pistol formation.
Probably going to see another deep shot here.
Cabron Cook, and I believe that was Michael Crawford, the wide receivers, as timeout called.
Luther, the second timeout of the half.
Luther must not have liked something they saw out there.
Maybe they had 10 guys on the field would be my guess, or 12. Just refs didn't notice yet.
Cheerleaders being lively as ever down there.
They're happy about the 50 burger.
Yeah. They're happy about everything. They always got so much energy down there.
That's true.
So, going into this halftime, I know Loras don't make much adjustments, but what would you do if you were the coach out there at halftime?
I'm Coach H?
Yeah. What would you be saying?
If I'm Coach Omeniak, I'm probably going to say defense, keep it up, keep the pedal to the metal. But on offense, I have to imagine they're going to ease up just a little bit. You still might see some passes, but things would be a far more, much more ground and pound attack second half. And if I was...
What if you were Luther's coach?
What
would you do?
I'm not sure.
Sigworth dropping back in the pocket. Pushed around. Nowhere to go. And he's brought down for, I believe, that's Luther's first sack of the game.
Yep.
And I believe Luther just called their third and final timeout. Oh, Loras.
Are you going to punt here?
Why'd Loras call their timeout there, EJ?
Well, I think they're thinking 7.7 seconds left.
Hail Mary?
If the Norris get the ball back, it won't be with much time, and he's probably going to throw it up, so there's also a good chance, or it could be an interception, more just an arm punt, you know?
So, with this possibly being like a Hail Mary type deal, who would the wide receivers you'd have out there be?
So, it's got to be like Monty, Cabron, Marty, and then I don't know if they're going to have maybe a McDevitt out there, or maybe they'd have Javon.
And then do you think they're just going to send them all to the end zone, or do you think they'll have like a little check down?
I'd be surprised if they have someone run like 20 yards downfield and stop and just try to have like the caravan escort them to the end zone.
Oh, it looks like they are going to punt it.
Oh,
as Sigworth has taken over most of the punting duties with the struggles they've had so far this year.
If they're going to punt, I'm so confused why they called a timeout.
Yeah. Sigworth gets a pretty good punt out. This one's going to get a Duhawk bounce. As they're all yelling, don't touch it. As it runs out of time.
What a half.
That was an amazing half.
We're halfway to the century mark, Hugh.
Yeah, so at the end of this first half, your Loras College Juwoks 50 and the Luther Norse 0. Catch back up with us at the start of the second half. Hello and welcome back to the Rock Bowl in this beautiful day. It's only gotten more beautiful with this 50-0 score, EJ.
Absolutely.
What are the stats you've got for us so far after that first half?
All right, so Siggy had one heck of a half. He was 13 of 19, 156 yards, and 4 touchdowns through the air. Also picked up 1 touchdown on the ground. And Eli Thomas had 85 yards, the long 70-yard run, 2 touchdowns. And really all for Luther so far is their punters having the day. 6 punts for 204 yards, a 34-yard average.
Yeah, and Alex Griffiths, who left the game early, is 1 for 10 with a... 1 passing yard.
Yeah. And then they've had to bring in the Wildcat quarterback, so they've changed up their offense a lot.
So I'm going to assume we're not going to see a whole lot more passing going on so far in this game. And what do you expect for this Duhawks offense or Duhawk team in general in the second half?
Well, it's probably going to be Devin, and then I wouldn't be surprised if we saw some of the freshmen or Garrett Hutchinson get in. Mm-hmm. And I'd also have to imagine it's going to be a lot of runs. It's probably going to keep the clock running. And then the Norse... probably also a lot of runs, but not by design, just because they have to.
We're going to be diving into this deep sheet here for...
I think that's probably the game plan for the second half for the
Especially Loras. Especially on the defensive side.
Both ways, for sure.
And it sounds like we're going to toss it down to our man on the sideline, Cade Messer. Cade, what do you got for us today?
put up 50 points on the offensive end, and they're on pace to break a school record that's over 100 years old. It was set in 1912. 82 points is the most points a Loras College football team has ever put up in one game. Like I said, that was set in 1912 against Wisconsin-Platteville. There's one other record that they're chasing here, too, is total yards of offense. In the first half, the Duhawks had 432 yards of total offense. The school record is 526 yards. That was set against the Luther Norse, who they are playing today. That was set in 2006. A little bit of fun fact and history for you before the second half begins. Back up to you guys.
Oh, my goodness.
What
Cade Messer. This man is just amazing.
He does not miss.
No.
He does not miss.
He is. He's just amazing. Words can't describe how amazing he is.
He brought the drip, and then he brought the facts.
He set a standard in his first performance as sideline reporter. He has set a standard.
Yeah.
He has set a standard for everybody.
Wow.
Now.
I find in the
Gave
hard.
Gave me goosebumps.
The
Gave
record,
me goosebumps. That's
the
how
record
good
watch
is.
It's
real now.
Yeah. I don't know about points. I feel like if we're going to have Devin and the second-string quarterbacks out, maybe not. But for yards, I feel like that's definitely attainable.
Yeah. I mean, we'd only need around 90 yards.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, well, I would love for me and you to be the ones to call the game we set the school record in points in.
That'd be amazing.
That would be.
1912, wow.
Yeah.
And then the yards also against Luther.
That'd be something. That would be something.
Yeah.
As Talbot out to kick it away once again. We've been saying his name a lot.
Touchback himself.
Zach's kick is away, and it's got a little bit of spin to it as Luther gets this one, and they're going to fair catch this one.
I'm surprised they're fair catching all of them. You'd think maybe once or twice they'd be like, all right, let's
try to get something going.
We don't have anything to lose. Down 50-0.
And some other Loras athletics going on. Today is the men's soccer team is playing the University of Dubuque in the ARC tournament final, and they are currently winning 1-0 in the 77th minute. The goal was scored in the third minute by Reed Miklavik, and this is a big game for the Duhawk men's soccer team, and hopefully they can pull this one out.
Rivalry game.
Yeah, especially for the championship, too.
Yeah.
Luther fakes the run. Are they going to throw it? Oh, they throw it! That ball is knocked incomplete. Josh Jones was pressuring the quarterback there for the Norse.
No one's really open on that play.
No.
Didn't look like he doesn't know how to throw a football, though.
That was actually a pretty good ball. Yeah. Pretty tight spiral. Also, the women's soccer team is playing tonight. They play right after the football game. I believe it's at 5 o'clock. They play Wartburg for the championship match in the ARC soccer tournament for the women's side. And it's here at Loras, so any of you Duhawk students listening, come out and support. It's a big game for the women's soccer team.
Still have not lost yet.
Yeah. Only have a draw, and that's a very good team. As Luther running down the sideline, Luther's quarterback knocked out of bounds by Mason Morris.
That was a very poor angle right there by number 3, Brett Bauer. Just ran like right behind him. You got to definitely keep him inside there.
Yeah. Parker Kaiser, the quarterback in for Luther, he's really showing that he can really run the ball. Really mobile quarterback.
The Luther offense has looked like they have much more life with Parker Kaiser.
Yeah, the defense seems like they've come out a little bit flat-footed here, started this second half.
Yeah.
But, I mean, is it hard to keep the intensity when you're up by so much, CJ?
Yeah, it does get a little mundane, but I'm sure they'll be up to it.
Luther looking to pass it. Kaiser says he throws it, and that ball is nowhere near the intended receiver.
I think we know why they're running the ball so much now.
Yeah. He hasn't really had much time either.
Mm-mm. Yeah, this Duhawk defensive line and linebackers are getting after him.
Yeah, they are. I'm seeing a lot of Duhawks getting loose over there on the sideline, too.
Everyone thinks they're about to get in, huh?
Yeah. Gotta love that mentality. Yeah. Sigurd's got the ball cap on.
His day's probably done.
Yeah. I mean, what a great day he's had, too. I mean, his first half stats are something some quarterbacks have all for a whole game.
Yeah.
Luther running this one, and they go nowhere. There's another Loras event, athletic event going on tonight, too, EJ. 7:30, the women's basketball team makes her home debut.
Let's go.
Is basketball your second favorite sport right after football, I assume?
Basketball might be number one.
Oh, really?
And that mean like baseball, whoa, too. I mean, it's hard to pick. I mean, just those three are definitely in the top three, though.
So it's like, say, take out if it's like the World Series or nothing. If football, baseball, and basketball is all on at once, which one are you going to pick? And like flipping through is like an option, but only with timeouts.
Let's go as Kent makes the play. Probably football, but to play
it also probably depends on the teams too.
Yeah, no, it depends on the teams 100%.
So like all three of your favorite teams are playing for each sport.
Football for sure.
Okay.
Definitely watch the Washington football
team.
Oh
yeah, you're a football team.
Sadly, man. Sadly I am.
Taylor Heinicke though. I love that man. He's a baller.
Yeah, but he's not good. So.
Wow.
I wish he was. I really wish he was.
Well, I mean, you guys had Dwayne Haskins, who amounted to nothing.
Yeah, well.
Backing up Big Ben now in Pittsburgh. As Luther's punt is up away. Ooh, that's a good punt. Going to let this one bounce, and it gets a Luther bounce.
Dude, their punter's having a day.
That was a good punt.
Seven punts. Two inside the 20.
His leg has got to be getting sore, tired at some point.
Yeah, he may have to walk on one leg back to the bus.
wrap it up with some ice and some heating.
Yeah.
Maybe get a massage. Yeah. Get a massage for him out there. Duhawks are backed up here. They're on their own 4-yard line. Devin Moore, quarterback in. And the running back is, looks, that's Ty. There's a flag on the play. And Ty gets a gain of around 2 or 3 yards.
Got to be holding.
As the refs are discussing what it is, and he's our official call.
Oh.
Oh,
let's go.
That helps out the Duhawk offense, moving them forward 15 yards.
Gives them some breathing room.
For being November 6th, actually a very beautiful day outside.
Yeah.
It's a very good day for football.
A great day for football.
Especially around the Rock Bowl and the Loras campus. All these trees, the leaves are turning. I mean, couldn't ask for a much better day. It's just
last game in the
beautiful,
Rock Bowl.
Yeah, for these seniors.
A lot of these seniors.
Who have really balled out, too.
Yeah. They left it all on the field for the last game. In the Rock Bowl, I should say, because next week's UD.
Yes, sir. Devin. Dropping back, looking to air this one out. Dwayne. Dwayne, catch that. Oh,
no.
The ref is saying no. He's out of bounds. That would have been an amazing catch there. It's kind of weird seeing Devin throw it as a lefty, throwing it like across his body.
Yeah.
It's definitely a change of pace.
Tough throw to make, too.
Yeah. Devin and Ty. In pistol formation in the backfield. Dwayne in the bottom of your screen. Eli in the flat. Ty bouncing around outside. He's stopped up by Luther and he's drove backwards after he stopped. After he gets a gain of around 3 yards. 21, Ty bounced with the carry to the 22-yard line. Tackled by number 26. Bringing up 3rd and 8 here for the Duhawks on their own 22-yard line. And EJ, you think they're going to pass it here or they're going
to
run it?
Yeah, I would not be surprised if they try to pick up first down. It might be a 3rd down passing only from here on out.
Devin alone in the backfield. 3-step drop. Gets out of his hands quick to Ty. Ty. Short of the first down, bringing up a 4th down for the Duhawks.
Are they going to go for it? That is the question. No, they're not.
Is Seward going to come back out to punt this? Or? Oh, no, we're going to have Farfan punt it.
Let's go. Run the fake. Now's the time.
Let him throw it. Would you want him to? Would you rather see him throw it or run?
Run.
It?
Run it. Well, give him the option. Have someone run down deep downfield.
RPO?
Yeah.
I'd like to see Farfan try and throw it. Oh, what is this?
interesting formation we got here for the Duhawks. Oh, Farfan's punt is away, and it looks like it's a good one. As Luther's going to fair catch that one.
Another fair catch.
Looks like they'll be seated at their own 38-yard line. EJ, what are some other football games going around the ARC today?
So today we got Dubuque at Central. We got Nebraska Wesleyan at Wartburg and BV at Coe.
And Wartburg coming off that tough loss to BV a couple weeks ago as Luther, his quarterback, bounced one to the outside. He's brought down by the Duhawks after a gain of 5 yards.
Yeah, that BV win over Wartburg, really a shocker.
Will Wartburg be coming out with a little bit mad against Nebraska
Wesleyan? Yeah, I think they might be taking some of their anger out on Nebraska Wesleyan, which could be very unfortunate for them because Wartburg is a great team.
Yeah, as you just saw that shot right there, Coach H talking to his offensive line there. What does an offensive line coach usually say to his offensive lineman? Is it a lot of technique stuff? Or?
Yeah, right now he's probably talking to you about technique or scheme, different fronts.
Mm-hmm.
They could be talking to some of the younger guys now, maybe if they're getting ready to go in.
This is now bringing up third down here for Luther after a gain of little to nothing. Third and three here for Luther. Oh, almost got the two walks to jump there. As Kaiser in the backfield, shotgun formation, fakes the handoff, looking to air it out on a little screen pass. That ball is overthrown, bringing up fourth down for Luther.
The blocker's got in the way of that pass right there. The screen pass is supposed to be behind the line, but I think he might have thrown it over the line right there.
Looks like they're gonna go for it here. Oh, nope, bringing out the punt team. Is this the punter's ninth attempt? I'm keeping count, or is it his eighth? Was his last one his seventh?
Last one was his seventh, so this is his eighth. He might get the 300 yards.
I mean, he's balling.
Yeah.
For as good as a punter can ball. Think Duhawks might get a block here, maybe? Nope. Punter's away, untouched, as Loras is going to make something happen with it. He's got room to go. He's going down the sideline. He's knocked out of bounds. The freshman for the Duhawks, number 5, Jake Rockweiler. The freshman out of Elkhorn, Wisconsin.
Great return.
Making some plays as a Luther player is down on the field.
Oh, no.
Luther has had a lot of guys go down with injuries in today's game.
Yeah. Just had an insult to injury at this point.
Yeah.
No pun intended, actually. I did not mean to.
As he's able to get off the field, looks like that's number 22, Zach Olson, the 6-foot linebacker out of Rochester, Minnesota.
Oh, Minnesota.
There's a lot of Minnesota guys. And most Alaskan players I've seen on our team so far this season, too.
I will have to say the same.
Devin and I believe that's Raddick in the backfield. Pistol formation, Devin. Quick screen pass to Crawford. Crawford
go
gets a few blocks.
Go, Crawford.
Bounce that outside. Brings it down to the Norse 29-yard line.
Yeah, I don't know if you knew, but he's my roommate.
Oh, really? He is? Actually heard the story. Do you want to tell the fans or the listeners the story about him having to go back to your house earlier before the game?
Oh, yeah. So it's a tradition. They always, in the locker room, break a chair to get hype. And they were looking for one, so they called me to bring one, but I was already leaving, so I think.
Cabrin Cook almost came down with a beautiful catch.
Almost with the catch of the year. He probably has 6 inches on the guy covering him right there.
He just has a, wow. Like the size difference between those two. It's like that DK Metcalf pitcher with, was it Lockett or was it Baldwin?
I can't remember. I know which pitcher you're talking about, though.
That's kind of what it reminds me of. But, yeah, then that have you, they called you asking for a chair you didn't have when they sent Crawford back to your house.
Yeah, sacrificed one of the chairs. But it's all right. We came out and dropped the 50 burger, so obviously it worked.
And then some. I mean, we still got plenty of time.
I'll offer up all of our chairs if this happens every game.
Especially for that UD game, went out for like three chairs up. Third and two here for the Duhawks. Devin Moore, pistol formation. Devin hands it off to Raddick. Raddick's got a hole. He's got one man to beat. Raddick for the touchdown. The senior scoring on senior day. Put six on the board for the Duhawks.
Great run right there.
Yeah. Raddick putting on the board for the Duhawks.
No way that arm tackle was going to stop him. He wanted it too bad. It's senior day. He needs to get in the end zone.
Yeah. As Sigrist back out on the field to hold this extra point attempt. Sigworth the holder, Farfan the kicker. Sigworth, good snap, good hold. Farfan's kick is up, and it is good. Again, the Duhawks a 57-0 lead here. As we see the replay here of this previous play. Yeah, Moore just hands it off to Raddick, and he makes a good cutback. And then he's got one man to beat, open field. Who's better? And that foul's got to go to Raddick right there.
Yeah. Very poor tackle attempt right there.
Yeah. Never want to try and arm tackle a big running back like that.
Especially when you're the last guy in front of the goal line. Talbot's having a day,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, he is.
Fair catch after fair catch.
Only if we had a stat for Talbot's kicks. We only got Sigworth's one punt for 60 yards.
I got a stat about Talbot's kicks.
Okay, yeah.
10 out of 10 would recommend the kick for any other team. Because it's going to be automatic fair catch.
Yeah.
At least today it has been.
Those spins he's had, he puts on those balls too?
I think it's only been two non-fair catches.
And one of them's because they dropped it. Yeah, look at that spin. That's
the fastest fair catch I think I've ever seen in my life. The second Talbot touched the ball, his hand was in the air.
He doesn't want to risk a fumble.
No. Got James Dixon out there, the senior from Union, Illinois.
Where's that at, EJ? Do you know?
It's right by Marengo.
Oh, okay.
You know?
I've heard of Marengo, yeah. Okay. Kaiser in shotgun formation. Keeps it on the QB read option. He's brought down by the Duhawks, number 11. Dawson Charlie.
Got Sean Doyle out there, too. Suddy. I think we got the Wellborns on the interior.
The Wellborns, two twin brothers that are seniors.
Oh, I am mistaken. I think it's one Wellborn and is that Dirtz?
Huh?
Yeah.
Or is it James Dixon? Luther hand this one off. Bouncing off a man. The ref's going to give him the first down. Looks like they are based off the spot where the line judges are.
Safety, we got Dustin Harris. Good to see him, the senior from Bettendorf.
And this just in, the Loras men's soccer team ends up winning the conference tournament against the University of Dubuque. 1-0.
Stand up, Duhawks.
That's a big win for our Duhawks men's soccer team. I know they struggled earlier in the year, and it's good to see them bouncing back win the conference tournament. Luther, hand this one off. Is there a flag on the play?
I think it might be a hold.
Yeah, it looked like a guy kind of got pancaked there with a hold. And the flag on the play.
Oh, That's a killer.
Yeah, it is.
They're getting some momentum.
The Duhawks have... They've only had one penalty, I believe, so far today, right? Two. The hold and then the roughing passer. A lot better than previous games.
Yeah. Way better.
Kaiser in the backfield. With, I believe, number 25, Avante Porter, the freshman from Houston, Texas. Kaiser completes a pass for a gain of around 2 yards as he stays in bounds and the clock keeps going. 6:30 and counting here to go in this third quarter.
Dubuque's own Andrew Hafel with the pressure on the quarterback right there.
What school did he go to?
He went to Hempstead.
Mm. The Hempstead Mustangs.
Mm-hmm.
What was Boylan's mascot?
The Boylan Titans.
Hmm, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Are you more of like an animal mascot fan or like or like a, I don't know, like a Titan or like a, you know?
Probably gets about 5 yards right there. Probably about I have to go probably other, because animals, you know, so common.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, everyone has, like, the lions, yeah, and, you know, the bears, like, the wolf, you know, there's all that. Unless it's, like, a random animal, mm-hmm, like, not one that's, like, commonly used, you
yeah
know? Like, what if there's, like, the zebras, you know?
Ooh.
Or, like, the meerkats?
Oh.
Like.
I think you got a chance at being, like, a PR
Should
rep.
I start being, like, a mascot
yes
designer?
Yes, 100%. 100%.
I don't know if that's a job.
I would root for the zebras. I mean, we got the zebras out there right now.
Yeah. Oh, the refs?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kaiser dropping back to pass it. And he's
intercepted! What a pick! What a pick!
Intercepted by number, I believe, is that 36? Brandon Phelps. Yep.
It was.
Brandon Phelps, freshman out of Morris, Illinois. That was a user lurk right there.
Yeah, wow. Diving pick right there.
Morris takes over first and 10.
At first, I thought it might have been a Foley.
There might have been six if it was a Foley. No, I'm just
kidding. EJ might have gotten a little bit louder if it was a Foley. Raddick's knocked down by his own blocker.
Yeah, it looked like he just got tripped up right there.
More half to Raddick up the middle.
Devin Raddick in the backfield. I believe that is Harrison.
Yep.
Willis, bottom of your screen. Monty Brown and Michael Crawford at the top of it. Harrison motions over. Now we got three receivers at the top of your screen. As Raddick motions out, leaving Devin alone in the backfield. Mike McDevitt is your tight end. Devin dropping back. Looking over the middle, I believe that his intended target was Mike McDevitt. He underthrew him there. So he was hit as he throws it.
Yeah, he couldn't really step into that one as he was getting hit right when he went to throw.
Now, Monty's the receiver at the bottom of your screen with Harrison and Michael Crawford at the top as a Luther player just slides into second base to get off the field there. Devin pushed out of the pocket, throwing it on the run. Hits Crawford, who gets both feet inbounds.
What a throw.
Good toe tap there by Crawford.
Yeah. On the run, rolling out.
All around, good play.
Getting two in.
This Hunter Machi checks in for Harrison Willis. Looks like Duke's getting the play in. 23 seconds left on the play clock. A little bit of Wildcat here. Devin motion on to wide receiver. Raddick on the Wildcat. Gets a good read. Raddick cutting it back. Devin laying a block. Put it on the board. Six for the Duhawks.
Wow.
Devin Moore absolutely laid out
a
person.
Yeah. He's 6'4", 225 coming at you.
I mean, I'd make a business decision there and just get out of the way. Raddick's second touchdown of the game.
That was a great run by Rag.
That
too
was.
Some great cuts he made, yeah.
Farfan the holder. No, not Farfan's the kicker, not the holder. Sigworth's the holder. Oh, and it's
That's not. Oh, Sigworth looking to throw it. Nope, he's going to run it. Sigworth. Oh, dives for the pylon. And
nope.
The ref's going to say he didn't get
it. Oh, I think he got it.
Yeah, I don't know about that one. I thought he got it.
Yeah. I said he.
Said he was short.
I don't know about that one. Sorry, as a fellow ref, I respect.
Oh my gosh, EJ, you're so kind. As we see the replay here, Rack, that's good vision by him. As we see right here, Devin,
boom,
lays the boom. Radic walks it in. I think Devin's just looking for somebody to hit there. That block didn't really need to be laid. Just looking for somebody to hit. As a quarterback, isn't going to do that much.
No. Ziggy and Devin both like to lay the big hits.
We see the crowd out there. Great work by our downfield cameraman, Bill Ellington. Bill.
Ellington? Ellentenny.
Ellentenny. Oh, shoot. My bad, Bill. I apologize, Bill. But, yeah, he's also a senior. It's Bill's last game.
Yeah.
In the Rock Bowl. I just want to give him a shout-out. He's been doing some great camera work.
Yeah, doing a great job in the camera.
As well as our replay runner, Hope.
The GOAT.
She's the Do Media Manager. Makes things run around this place.
Mm-hmm.
As I believe Kaiser coming back out in the field here for Luther. Don't think they have.
Yeah. I know Hope and Bill were both very emotional about this being their last game in the Rock Bowl.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. How can't you be emotional about it?
Yeah.
I'm just emotional about it being my last game for the season.
Yeah.
You know, it's just
sad. Definitely cried myself to sleep last night.
Oh, that's understandable.
Yeah.
As Luther gets a gain of, looks like 4 yards there on first down.
I'd be surprised if Bus gets a couple
carries. Oh, the Bus.
Yeah. Or Jamel.
Mm-hmm. Haven't seen a whole lot of him after.
Yeah, he's
been in for a few plays, not this game, but last game we had. But
I'm sure they're going to try to give Rad a couple more touches, though, since it's
senior
day. Yep.
Kaiser hands it off. Oh, jumps over his own lineman as there is a flag on the play. And as we wait to hear what this call is going to be from the refs, they're moving them back, so I'm going to assume it's going to be a hold.
Holding. Offense number 16. Sign up.
It's like every time Luther starts to get something going, they just take a couple steps back.
Yeah. So, EJ, I see these coolers over there on the training table. Are those filled with water, or is that like Gatorade or Powerade in there? What was it when you played?
I'm trying to remember. I think one was water, or like three of them are water. One might be Powerade, or.
And if, as Kaiser moves up in the pocket, he's got a lot of daylight, he's brought down by Brandon Phelps making the tackle there.
Have a day, Phelps.
Yeah, tackle and an interception. If you had to rank the Gatorades in color, what would your order be?
Well, I'm a big G-Zero guy. I'm a zero sugar type.
Okay.
I think those ones taste.
I can respect it.
They taste like a little bit different, but I don't think it's like worse, I would say. Just different.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if it has no sugar, why not? You know,
yeah, why not? Be healthy.
But I'm going to go yellow, orange, white, blue.
Okay.
That's my Mount Rushmore. Okay. And then, like, probably red.
Yeah. Red's classic.
Yeah. You never
red
go wrong
classic.
With it. You never like, I want a red Gatorade, but you're never like, no, I'm not going to drink it.
Yeah. He's like, I mean, it's here, I'll drink it, but, like, if there's other options, you know? Luther making a good cutback on the run.
Great cutback and good job jump over his own offensive lineman
number
right there.
Number 39, Mentor Cooper, the freshman from Muscatine, Iowa.
What's the scouting report on Muscatine here?
Let's see here. I know they have a high school there called Muscatine. I want to say their mascot is
You don't know.
It's a dude with like a hat and he's got a mustache.
You
it's
don't
like,
know.
It's like a pirate or
You're
something
just
like
making that,
that
up.
No, I'm serious. I think that's what it is. Don't quote me on it, though. As Kaiser gets the snap, hands it off, and they're just getting a whole bunch of holes now.
Wow.
As Cooper takes that one for a first down, then some.
The ground attack looking pretty good so far against a lot of young guys in for the Duhawks.
Yeah. Maybe not. Don't have a whole lot of, you know, experience or any of that stuff.
Got Jack Deegan and Milo in there on the defensive line, along with James Dixon and Patrick Suddy.
Kaiser, backfield. Duhawks have plenty of guys in the box. They hand off to Cooper, and Cooper goes nowhere.
Duhawks all over that.
It is the Muscatine Muskies is their mascot.
So you were wrong.
I was completely wrong. I don't know what school I was thinking of. I was 120% wrong.
I think you're just making up a school.
I'll admit it. I was wrong. Maybe I was.
Did your school make the playoffs for football?
Yeah, they made the first round, and then they lost in the first round. They lost to Iowa City Regina.
Oh.
Who was undefeated.
Powerhouse.
Yeah. And I believe we're two-way for football or one-way. As Cooper has a good burst of speed there for a first down. Oh, that's not Cooper. That's number 25, Avant Porter, the freshman from Houston, Texas. As I will assume that will be the last play for Luther. For this third quarter. At the end of the third quarter, your Loras College Duhawks 63, Luther North 0.
So I believe we're going to get the stats here after the end of this quarter, mm-hmm. but I'd not be surprised if we broke the record.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised either. Actually, let's see if I can pull up on the live stats here.
The points is going to be tough.
Yeah, we'd have to score, what was it, 82?
Yeah, it was 80-something.
Yeah. So we'd need 20 points.
I think we need some. We need a defensive score in there.
Mm-hmm.
We have a winner in today's 50-50 drawing. It's a red ticket. The number is 1-3.
If I'm reading this correctly, we have 540 total yards of offense. If I'm looking at this correctly, pretty sure the record was.
I think it was less.
I don't know.
I think we
no.
Broke
what
it.
Were we at halftime? Do you remember?
It was four. Wait, we have.
We only needed 90 or something like that.
Yeah, we need around 90 total offense. Wait,
we're at 442.
442. So it must have been like 550 or 530.
Yeah, I think it was like 5:30. So
pretty sure we broke the record. Unofficial breaking news.
Yeah, unofficial breaking news. The 2021 Loras College football team has just broke the total offensive yards record.
Yeah, set in 2006 against
Luther,
the Norse.
A little anticlimactic that, but yeah.
Yeah. How do you feel about the blue field the Norse have? Are you anti? Are you pro? Are you indifferent?
No, I mean, I think it's cool.
Yeah, I think it's cool.
Nothing wrong with like a classic like this Loras field though. Nothing wrong with classic.
Oh yeah, I'm more of a grass guy though, as we said before.
Yeah,
I'm not really a turf guy.
Is turf burn real? Is it real?
Oh yeah, 100%. Dude, Joey had really bad turf burn. Like his arm was like messed up really, really bad.
Is turf burn, how much worse is that than carpet burn, would you say?
It is worse. I don't know how much worse, but like obviously when you're playing football on it, it's going to
be a lot worse.
Yeah, you're running full speed and getting tackled into the ground at full speed. So,
do you get a lot of turf burn when you played or no?
Nah. No. Well, at high school, we played on grass,
okay.
And then away stadiums would be turf, but.
As Kaiser keeps it on the read option.
Oh.
Stiff arms a man. Kaiser breaking it. Oh, fumble. Who's got it? Dogpile here. Let's see.
The Hawks might be bailed out here if he fumbled right there. Cause
I almost thought Kaiser was going to take that one to the end zone. And looks like the rest point at Luther. Yep, Luther ball.
Zacchaeus Knighton right there. Kind of got stuck on the block out there by that receiver.
And like we said in previous games, Zacchaeus is more of a pass coverage guy.
Yeah.
Tackling is not a strong suit.
Yeah. Great in coverage, though. He's sticks to you like glue.
Kaiser in the backfield with, that looks like number 39, Mentor Cooper. Yep. Kaiser fixed the handoff to Cooper, looking to air it out. Throwing it to Phelps, and
That's like offensive pass interference. Looked
yeah,
like
brought him down with him.
He grabbed his arm and just didn't want him to get his second pick of the game,
yeah.
I guess. Because Zach came on the blitz right there.
Andre Atkins was the intended receiver.
Yeah, before the game, talking to Joey and Jack Foley about this Norse team, they were saying that they have how much respect they have for Andre Atkins, that mm-hmm. he's an all-conference receiver level. But so far this game, he really hasn't been able to do much.
Atkins, 6'2", 160, senior out of Redwood City, California.
Ooh, wow. This team's all
over. Yeah, they're all over the place.
Wow. Redwood City.
Never heard of it, actually. Yeah, wow. So they hand this one off, and ooh, wow. Phelps kind of came in there with like a missile.
Yeah. Have a game, Phelps.
Third and one here. No, third and seven here for the Luther Norse on the Duhok 14-yard line.
You can see the Luther fan still waving the flag.
You
got to respect that. Gotta
that's
respect
that's commitment.
Yeah,
that's
never
commitment.
Give up. Never give up on the boys.
It's like John Cena says, never give up. Kaiser in the backfield with Porter, and there's a timeout on the play. Looks like Luther called it.
Other college football news, Illinois with an upset over number 20 Minnesota today. So.
Oh, Illinois, your favorite college to root for?
Yeah.
Football-wise?
Yeah.
And basketball also?
Yep. Not really much to root for in football, though we did beat Penn State and Minnesota this year. So.
Oh, so I mean, two of the best teams
yeah.
in the Big Ten.
I mean, the Big Ten West this year was a disaster, though, so the East has all the good teams.
Yeah.
Michigan State, Ohio State in the East.
That Michigan State game was a very good game. Did you watch any of it?
I did. Michigan State.
Very good game.
Yeah. But, unfortunately, I feel like Ohio State's just going to run them over.
Well, with that attitude, yeah. They need fans. You got to be like that Luther fan, waving that flag around
you know
there.
What? You're right.
You got to keep supporting no matter what, man.
The shout out to my parents. They just told me Boylan Soccer is state champions.
Oh.
Yep.
Congratulations to Boylan Soccer.
Yep.
As Kaiser hands it off. Pretty close to the first down, probably around four or 3 yards short.
These freshman running backs have looked pretty good today.
Yeah, they got
so
quick bursts of speed.
Yeah, and they're not going down easy. It takes a couple guys to tackle them usually, and they have pretty good vision also.
Yeah, they do. As number 93, Mason Ross, the sophomore out of Queen Creek, Arizona. Oh, wait, nope, this is a Luther one. As number 93 for the Duhawks, Jack Deegan, the junior out of Williamsburg, Iowa, checks out the game for the Duhawks. They hand this ball off, and fourth down. Looks like Duhawks stopped them.
Let's go.
So Luther's going to have to wait to get on that scoreboard. And 11:45 left to go. They might only have one or two more chances at it.
Yeah, the Duhawks want this shutout, though.
Yeah, they do. I wonder if Cade knows how many times that the Duhawk football team has shut out a team.
Cade is our records guy.
I know.
So.
I wonder if he knows. He's probably got a whole bunch of stuff that
he studied the archives.
Yeah, I could see it. He put in the work, and you know, you gotta give him the hat, gotta give him a tip of the cap for it. As the Duhawks hand this ball off to
CJ Bauer, looks like. Yep, Colton Bauer.
senior from Galena, Illinois.
Right across the bridge.
Yeah. First time we've said his name all season, actually.
Yeah.
As there's another Luther player down on the field. So at halftime, I got told that my little cousin, who's watching the broadcast right now, just finished his football season. He's going into basketball season.
Let's go.
Yeah. Gotta give best of luck to you, Owen.
Let's go, Owen.
And then my grandparents actually celebrated I believe it was their 70th wedding anniversary.
Wow.
Yeah, 70th wedding anniversary.
Good to see.
Yeah, good to see him get off the field. Second and 7 here for the Duhawks on their own 13-yard line. Devin in the backfield along with Colton Bauer. Devin gets the snap. Fakes the handoff. Overthrows Harrison Willis. Let him a little too far over the middle.
You have to slam him a little too much. Would have been a nice one-handed catch.
Mm-hmm. I would have been.
We got Jaheim out there. Jaheim Haynes. Lives right below me. Him and Milo.
Oh, he does?
Yep.
Keep everything calm, I assume they do.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's good.
Don't really see him too much. They're always at football, you know.
Yeah. As Devin's brought down for a sack here. Luther's second sack of the game. Second sack of the game and their 17th on the season.
One other nice thing I'd say about Luther, their helmets. I like their helmets. The numbers on the side.
Yeah, they do have. It's a nice little classic look.
Yeah.
The helmets on the numbers on the side. Sigworth out to punt it here.
I mean, what can't Siggy do? We've seen him line up as a receiver, a running back.
He's a jack of all trades, yeah. And he's a very good punter, too.
He does have a boot.
Mm-hmm, he does. And speaking of our downfield cameraman, Bill, he's got a segment on Do Media called Lost in the Hot Sauce.
Yep.
Where he brings in people and asks them questions, and he eats them. Oh, my gosh. And they eat wings together with, like, hot sauce and all that stuff.
Yep, yep.
And speaking of wings, DJ, do you have, like, a go-to wing or any type of wings or sauces?
A sauce? I'm a big garlic parmesan and spicy garlic from B-Dubs, but as far as like Wingstop, I like the lemon pepper and I can't think of the other one.
Luther has
trick play.
Quarterback wide open.
No. Get him. Chase him down.
Oh.
There goes the shutout. What a trick play.
That was actually a pretty good play.
Yeah.
As I believe that was number 80. Was that Atkins? Andre Atkins threw it to Kaiser for the touchdown.
Yeah, what a play.
They caught us. They got the Duhawks sleeping. And they caught us talking about wings.
They caught everyone sleeping. Everyone was lacking.
Are you a bone-in or bone-out wing guy?
I'm versatile. I can go both ways. I usually more bone-in, but or bone out, but I would eat bone in, no problem.
I don't know why, I just like boneless more. You keep your hands cleaner.
That's true. That is a big advantage.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, lemon pepper. That's the other one I thought of. That one is insane.
As
parm, garlic, and lemon pepper.
The kick is up, and it is a...
That'd be blocked.
Yeah. I believe that was number 88, Parker Gallagher, the sophomore out of Delhi, Iowa, with the kick. As we see the replay here, this Luther touchdown. I mean, just... That's a good throw on the run, too.
Yeah.
And Kaiser just ran that one in.
Yeah, no one near him.
Yeah. Great camera work, too, by our camera operators.
Yeah.
That's some good job.
They were in their bag on that play.
Yeah, they were. They've done a pretty good job on all the stuff today, too.
Dang, I really want to shut out.
That would have been good. That would have been nice.
So I think Rockweiler is going to take this one to the crib.
Oh, yeah. Oh, is that Jack Foley back there receiving, EJ?
Jack Foley and Rockweiler.
Jack Foley? Take him to the house?
Yeah, I hope he returns it. I hope he does not
fair
catch it.
I hope he returns it, too.
If he fair catches it, I'm going to boo him later when I see him.
Going to walk over to where he's living and just start booing him.
Or maybe let's do another pooch like they did in start the game.
First time we've heard Welcome to the Jungle by Guns N' Roses all day, isn't
it?
Yeah. Dang. The kick is up, and there's a way. It's a spiraling kick. It's going to bounce out of bounds, and that'll be a flag.
Kind of jinxed Luther. I said they haven't really been flag heavy this year.
Yeah.
And then today they've had quite a few
penalties. Yeah. Does the ball just move forward to the 35 on a kick out of bounds?
I think it depends.
Depends on where it goes out.
Yeah.
They should have him just re-kick it and then
kick it to Jack.
And then Jack can return it for a touchdown. Number 80 is in for the Dewhawks. Jaheim Haynes. As well as number 14. Is that our man Nolan Schwartz?
It is.
It is our man Nolan Schwartz. A member of Dew Media. He's got a segment on YouTube as well called Noli's Hotspots, where he goes around the area for college kids looking at fun places to go and hang out.
Mm-hmm.
Very nice segment. Yeah. He had a very good one where he went to Dark Chambers. I believe that was his most recent one.
Yeah, the haunted house.
Yeah, it's pretty fun to watch. Our man, Nolan. And that is Michael Crawford, the receiver at the top of your screen, and Hunter Machi is the tight end. Devin dropping back, hits Crawford under the middle. Crawford with a stiff arm. Staying in bounds. Oh, the ref.
There we go.
Them out of bounds. And it looks like the ref is going to give him a first down.
Mark him out at the 45.
It's pretty close. Oh, the sticks are giving him a first down, but yep, there. Third down. Oh, nope.
Nope.
Head officials moving him down.
Yep.
Wide receivers. Got a three bunch here at the bottom of your screen. Crawford at the top. Devin. Gets off to Jaheim. Jaheim making a couple guys miss off a good block there by Nolan Schwartz.
Dew Media is known for the blocking.
Yeah. We're known for those grinders out there, you know?
Yeah.
Does the dirty stuff.
Yeah. If he scores a touchdown.
Oh. We have to
go. That might be the greatest moment in Dew Media
history.
That would.
I mean, got to represent. Yeah. You got to represent for Dew Media. Devin. Hand it off. Oh!
Colton Bauer!
Bauer's got some room on
Let's
the sideline.
What a run. He turned on the Jets right there.
Yeah, he did. Getting it out to around the 30-29-yard line, picking up the first down. Keeping the chains moving for the Dewhawks. The Dewhawks have 23 first downs in today's game. Compared to Luther's 11.
That's got to be a record, probably. 23 first
probably.
Downs.
Probably. The Dewhawk football program has just gotten better and better every year.
breaking a bunch of records today.
Yeah. Devin looking to hit Crawford. Crawford making a guy miss and getting that first down.
Can I get 24? All right, Nolan's next.
I mean, Nolan's just, I mean, yeah. Look at his being guarded right
They've
now.
They've hit Crawford. Oh. They hit Jaheim.
Gotta be Nolan. Gotta be Nolan. Yeah. Have Nolan run across the middle there. Oh, easy. He can get him. Devin dropping back to Jaheim. Jaheim. A game around 3 yards there. I really thought he was throwing that one to Nolan.
So
I thought Nolan running that corner around to the corner of the end zone. Devin and Bauer in the backfield. Looks like Mike McDevitt's our tight end. Jaheim, bottom of your screen.
Kind of surprised we haven't seen any of the younger tight ends. It's been all Machi and McDevitt.
As Bauer goes nowhere. Bringing up a third and four here.
All right, now's the perfect time. No one's expecting it.
Mm-hmm.
Third down to...
Third and eight, excuse me, not third and four.
That'd be a long 4 yards.
Yeah, yeah. Got to give it to Nolan. He's just a playmaker out there.
Mm-hmm. Well, it does appear that Jaheim has a linebacker on him.
Getting out to Crawford. Crawford having to come forward. Oh, Gavin! Was that bounce though, right?
Yeah.
Close to the first down marker.
I believe he got it.
And, oh, the ref is going to have to review. Getting the sticks, getting the chains out there. Looks like. And it's either fourth down or first down. And it is fourth down here. Looks like Devin's going to sneak it.
Got it.
Devin using that big frame of his, 6'4", 225. Not a lot of people going to be able to stop that.
Mm-mm.
You got to give credit to the Sleuther fan base. So they're still sitting out here.
Mm-hmm.
They're sitting over there in front of Roman Hall.
Mm-hmm. They're not giving up on the boys.
No. And looks like another Luther player is injured.
Hey, an unfortunate day with the injuries so far.
There's been a lot of them. Playing some good jams, too.
Starting to get a little cooler out now.
Yeah. Well, I just see some fans over there in the Hennessy Hall parking lot right across from the Science Hall. Looks like they're tailgating during this game watching it.
That's a pretty good spot.
Yeah.
You can see everything.
Loras on the hill, I mean, you get a good view of, like, the bridges and everything, too, from the library.
Yeah.
As the Luther player is able to get up off the field, but does need some assistance coming off.
Talked about earlier, had that two thumbs up pulled pork sandwich.
Mm-hmm.
Once again, I would give it two thumbs up.
Two thumbs up?
Yep.
Oh, dang. Okay.
They don't miss.
They keep it consistent.
They don't miss.
And fans are going to have to wait till next year to have it again.
Yeah.
I don't think they sell that basketball games.
Or they could buy it at the soccer game.
Oh, look at you, EJ. Yeah. If you want that two thumbs up pulled pork sandwich, come to the women's soccer game.
Mm-hmm.
It can be your supper meal.
Yeah.
Or dinner, as some people call it.
Yeah. Keep you warm.
Yeah.
Too.
I saw you eating and I saw like the steam coming off of it too.
Put some mustard on it?
No. I almost put ketchup on my hot dog just out of spite, EJ, but... As there is a whistle on the field. Loras calling their first time out of the second half.
Yeah, I don't think they could get the formation right there.
Kind of surprised. Do you think this is going to be Devin's last drive of the game?
I think they're probably going to let him finish this one out, honestly. I don't know. I'm not sure how confident they are in the other quarterbacks.
Yeah. And it will more than likely be Devin's show next year, too, with Sigworth being gone.
Yeah, yeah.
Are they going to – do you think there will be some changes to some of the plays? Because I know this offense is more designed for, like, a mobile quarterback, and Devin's not the mobilest guy coming off those surgeries.
Yeah, I think they're going to have to, and he's a lefty, but so this, like, roll, if he does roll out, just rolling out the other way. But
is that the really only change for lefties is the way they roll out?
Yeah. Well, in Devin, I'm not sure how much they want him to roll out considering his injury history. He might just want him to stay more in the pocket.
Bowers in the backfield with Devin. Jaheim, is that the bottom of your screen?
No one
in motion. Oh, they handed off to Bauer. Bauer, the senior.
Did he get in?
Yes! Give him the touchdown.
Let's go.
Put it on the board. Six for the Duhawks.
Dang, if we get to 70, that's like the fries. Like, we already got the burger. We just need 70 to get to the fries.
What about, like, a drink with it? What do we need for that?
That's 100, that's the whole meal. You got a drink and a cookie. If it's
I don't think we're getting that one.
No.
As Sigworth will be holding it here, and Farfan will be kicking it. Hopefully putting the Duhawks at 70. Good snap. Oh. The ball is blocked, and Sigworth just got laid out.
He just stayed there. Wow.
Farfan's gets his second extra point attempt blocked of the game as we see the replay from this last. Colton Bauer just powered through there and dove for that goal line to get that touchdown. He really wanted that on senior day.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Got to give a shout-out to Coach Helminiak and his assistant coach is getting these seniors in there, giving them those scoring opportunities.
Yeah, getting them all the touches.
We've heard this fight song a lot today, too.
I think they should give Dirtz one carry. Oh. I just want to see what that would look like.
Yeah.
Because it's going to take a lot of guys to bring him down unless you can just trip him.
Probably. Looks like the Duhawks are getting quarterback warmed up down there on the sideline. It's like that's number 12, Evan England, the 6'2", 285-pound freshman out of Wheaton, Illinois.
Wow. Let's go.
As number 3, Johnny Carson, the second freshman out of Lutz, Florida, was the running backs catching balls for him. As Luther fair catches that one. 6:25 left to go here in this game. Your Loras Cross Duhawks 69, the Luther North 6.
Got Rashad Johnson, the DB out of Tampa, Florida, hun. Haven't called his name yet this year.
We have not.
And I think we got Oquendo. Yep, the safety, the team favorite, Jacob Oquendo. He's the life in the locker room. He's always cracking jokes, just walking around the locker room, you know, talking to everyone.
Always good to have those guys in the locker room. Yep. Keep things light. As the refs are having conversation here. I don't know what this conversation could be about.
I think they might have been talking about that kickoff. Because he started to run forward. But I think he called a fair catch. So.
Oh, okay.
Sad and Rashad slip are flipping sides on the field now.
Kaiser in at quarterback. Kaiser gets the snap. Hands off to his running back, who's brought down after a gain of 1 yard there. 6:15 and counting here.
Luther is they're promising young skill players, so I will say that like both the running backs they look good.
And then their quarterback who went out the injury, Griffith, is he's only a sophomore.
Yeah. Like we said, he is the look of a quarterback.
Yeah, he does. Got everything you want in a quarterback with the height. He's not a small person either. Listed at 210.
Yeah.
Luther, jet touch pass. Got a few blocks. He's got a hole, but he's brought down by the Duhawks. Looked like that was number 83 for Luther.
You already know the quarterbacks love the little touch pass and set hand off so they can get their stats, yeah.
Number 83, Cannon Reitz, the 5'11 senior out of Edmond, Oklahoma.
Wow. They might have all 50 states.
Yeah,
covered.
I think he's a transfer from Steamboat Springs, Colorado. First
down. They got a couple Colorado guys. A couple California.
Kaiser gets the snap. Hands it off to his running back. He's got a big hole. Avante Porter hitting the big hole there, getting the first down for Luther.
Two Hawks, unfortunately, there wasn't more right there.
It looks like he had
even numbers with the blocking, but fortunately for the Dawes, they were able to bring him down.
And with those even numbers, EJ, does that really come down to better blocking versus better block shedding?
Yeah, I'd say that. And then also the ball carrier's vision, deciding where if he's going to cut back or keep running.
Mm-hmm. Kaiser in the backfield with, looks like Porter. Hands off to Porter. Porter doing his best to get back to the line of scrimmage, and looks like he got a yard out of it. Or half a yard, I should say. 4:20 and counting here for the remaining of this game. Second and nine here on the 50-yard line.
So Quendo playing, oh, he's playing linebacker, wow. And Luke Bolstad, my roommate last year, linebacker, the Pride of Hananiga. They're up currently in their playoff game.
Oh, playing on a Saturday?
Yeah, Boylan is playing today too.
Oh, I didn't know high schools played on Saturdays.
Just for state tournament? Playoffs, yeah. Okay. I think some high schools do actually play on Saturdays, though.
For like the state championship games in Illinois, do you go to like is it at like the home team's place or do you go to like
no,
the stadium or something?
No, it was, I think it's been at Soldier Field, I think, and I think it's been in Champaign.
Okay. I know Iowa's has played at the UNI, the Uni Dome.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's where
that place
Iowa's
is cool.
Played. Yeah, it's pretty nice. Because you know Iowa, no professional sports teams.
That's pretty unfortunate.
I know, it's kind of sad.
Yeah.
But it just lets me root for teams all over, I guess.
That's true.
As Kaiser, the shotgun formation, hands off to Porter. Porter runs into just everybody and brings up fourth down after no gain. Fourth and three here for Luther with 3 minutes left in the game. They're on the Duhawk 44-yard line.
Come on, boys, let's get a stop here.
Let's see the freshman. I want to see the freshman, Evan England, come in and play. I mean, I don't know if we'll see him throw it, but still.
Maybe get a preview of next year or the years to come.
Yeah. Fourth down here. Kaiser alone in the backfield. I could almost see this being a QB draw, maybe. Kaiser pushed out of the pocket by Milo. Oh, and he shovel passes it. Oh, that would have been a very nice play as that ball was dropped out of bounds.
I thought for sure it was going to be a QB draw, but they actually were trying to pass it. Yeah. I couldn't believe that.
He was pressured by number 42, Milo. Is it Coolier? Is that what he said?
Collier, I think.
Collier. The 6-foot, 200-pound junior from Freeport, Illinois.
Yeah, they're in the same conference as my high school boy.
Oh, so do you remember playing him in high school?
Yeah. Well, not him specifically, but after high school, we talked about it.
As the freshman, number 12, Evan England, coming in the game. Oh, a little check down pass.
Rockweiler.
To Rockweiler. Got all. Got a lot of freshmen. Freshman.
Tight end in there, too. Number 87, Owen Libby. 6'2", 230 from Florida. Wesley Chapel.
Big guy.
What do you know about Wesley Chapel, Florida?
I know nothing about. I only know like three cities in Florida. It's like Miami. Is it Cape Cod? That's in Florida, right?
No, I don't think so.
Oh.
Okay. I'm pretty sure that's like Northeast, right?
I don't know. That's why I don't know. I know I'm going to Destin, Florida for spring break this year with my family. So,
nice. Yeah. That'll be That'll be a lovely trip.
It'll be fun. It'll be a nice, relaxing trip. As we got a minute 35 left to go here in the game. And the Duhawks' final game at the Rock Bowl for this season. It's been a fun one. It's been a memorable one.
Yeah, it's been great getting to call games with you, Hugh.
EJ, it's always a blast. Looking forward to next year.
Jaheim.
Bringing up fourth down and two here on the 50-yard line. Shotgun formation. Rockweiler in England backfield.
Oh, no.
Bad snap. Rockweiler picks it up. Trying to make a couple guys miss.
No.
Oh, and he stumbles. It looks like there was a flag on the field, though.
If he would have stayed on his feet, he would have picked it up for sure.
Looks like a flag is on the field. I feel like they jumped. I thought I saw motion. Yep.
Let's go. That's probably why there was a snap.
Yeah. And do you think, do they practice that? Like if the center sees somebody jump to just snap it or no?
Yeah, I don't know if necessarily practice it, but that's definitely communicated by the coaches. Mm-hmm. Like if you see someone jump, snap it, you get a free play, you know?
Yeah. I know Aaron Rodgers likes to get those offsides and chuck it downfield. England fakes a screen pass. Oh, they're going to our man Nolan Schwartz. England, as there's two flags on the play, laundry all over the field here.
They're trying to go to Schwartz.
They were. The deep Luther had it sniffed out.
They read the scouting report.
Yeah, they knew he was a deep threat.
They know. They've watched Nolly's hot spots.
Yeah,
they know.
They know what's up. Yeah, exactly. A 10-yard penalty. Push it first and 20 here for the Duhawks on their own 45-yard line. With 32 seconds left here to go. Man, I just really want to see a Nolan Schwartz touchdown.
Yeah, just give him a touch at least.
Yeah, we need one of them.
You got to put the ball in your playmaker's hands.
Yeah,
you know?
And let him make a play. Oh, they dump it off to Rockwell, who is tackled for a loss of 3 yards. Bringing up second and 23 here. The Duhawks going to run another play here with 14 seconds left to go, EJ?
No. No way, right? Yeah.
Yeah, it looks like England's walking off the field.
Wow. What a game.
That was an amazing game. Great way to end the season for the Duhawks.
Great last game in the Rock Bowl for all these seniors who put in all the hard work and dedication to this program for 4 or 5 years for some of them.
At the end of this game, your Loras College Duhawks 69, the Luther North 6, and EJ, I just want to thank you for calling these games with me all season. It's been a blast.
Hugh, it's been so much fun calling these games with you. It's an honor to get to do this with you every Saturday.
It's so fun. I look forward to it. And this isn't Loras' last game of the season. They do have that big cross-city rivalry against UD in a week.
With a team up the street.
Yeah, and that's going to be a big game. So any of you Dubuque people or Loras students, make sure you get out to that game. And so that'll wrap up our Duhawk season calling football. And we actually do have basketball games next week that we are working on. So make sure to tune in to that. And just want to thank you for listening to us all season long. See you guys next year.
Peace.